Are your guests in the studio yet? I actually have a question for Kurt.
Kurt's in the Besho VIP lounge.
Oh, shoot. I should have called later.
He'll be coming into the studio shortly. Why don't you give me the question and I'll relay it?
I kind of wanted to hear his reaction.
Kurt, I'm bringing him in just for you, Kat.
Oh, thank you.
What?
What? He's come stomping. Wait, first of all, what's with the camera with this? It's always a new angle with you. What are you, Ralph Cramden, right?
We've been working on the dumbest documentary ever. It's gonna have an award for the best, most dumbest documentary ever.
It's gonna have okay.
But we just have to have you in it. All right, that's enough.
Jell-O Man is filming in here.
I'll take it off if you want.
That's all right. Look, you guys do what you're gonna do.
We won't do it without asking you twice.
All right, now stop talking. I'm just kidding.
I can't handle. He's, first of all, Jell-O Man, your brother, Kurt, is, he's a man of many talents. And now photography apparently is one of the many things you bring to the table. Right? So you're making a documentary?
Not really, but, you know, I remember actually Paul called when he was filming a lot of stuff, the making of the last record, and we just picked it up again randomly. This is fun, and we just thought we should have you in it. So now you're in it. All right, now
there
stop.
I told him to ask you first.
Just kidding.
It's like your security. He just hovers, and he... I didn't say you couldn't hover. All right, but get out. It would be better without you in here. Kurt Vile, welcome.
Thanks.
Back to the airwaves. Kat, our caller here, has a question for you.
Go ahead.
Okay, so what I've been thinking for a long time is, first of all, do you know how, like, for a while, people would heckle Ryan Adams by, shouting Summer of 69 at him, and then after a while he gave in and actually played Summer of 69?
Who's Ryan Adams? I never heard of him.
Oh, he was a musician, and...
Was?
Or he is.
Still is.
He's not dead as far
yeah,
as
you're
I
writing
know.
Him off like it's a... No.
Yeah, I would fight for you.
Okay, so, yeah, yeah. His name was like Brian Adams.
Okay. Yeah.
So what I'm wondering is, has anyone ever heckled you except they shout, Max the Knife! Max the Knife!
The most annoying version of that is when stuffy types on message boards or whatever else act like they're the first person who thought,
what's he going to play? The Three Penny Opera? Like the real Kurt Vile?
You know, I don't know. I just don't like when people think they thought of that for the first time. It's like,
yeah.
You know, Kurt Vile. It's easy.
Hey, Mike. You might not want to do that thing you said you were going to do earlier. Mike was going to do a whole 10-minute thing on Three Penny Opera tonight that he's been working on all week. So you might want to ice that, Mike.
I was like, what did he do last time? What did he sing last time?
The Boxer.
Oh, yeah. For the halls on 8th Avenue.
And I'm waking up in my winter clothes and wishing I was home, going home.
But I get no offers.
Who's that, Wally Wackyman?
No, that's the way he sounded.
Who did, Mike?
Mike.
Looking for a job, but I get no offers. Ah, saw the whores on 7th Avenue.
Yeah, he was a little too... And didn't he change it to 8th Avenue
yeah,
or something?
Exactly.
Weirdly specific. I think I'm going to punch up Paul Simon's lyrics and make it 8th Avenue. Would you get a commission? And I'll say this. This AP Mike, he's one of the best guys I ever met in my life. I think about the day I met him. He came in here, took over from the previous call screener, Matt. Found Mike, came in. Mike thought he was 1 week and out. He thought he was boring. I thought he was perfectly fine. I wanted boring. He was like, was I too boring? I'm like, look, yeah, it was perfect. You were so boring, it was ridiculous. And then finally, one year in, he says to me, the moment that it made this chapter of your life, Mike. Why don't you watch this movie, Strozik? It's funny. If you didn't do that, Mike, who knows where you'd be? Who knows where I'd be? I certainly wouldn't be here today, and that's so far. I'll be eternally grateful for that moment, Mike, that you thought the Werner Herzog movie Strozik was funny. Do you know about these master classes, Mike? You got one? Yeah, Werner Herzog has a master class where he... That seems like a little bit of a rook. Like he's like going to teach you how to direct. It's like, really? He's really going to give the secrets away? Because then his things are always just like, he always has like weird advice. He's just like, you should stop watching movies. Okay, what? Okay, stop watching movies. Okay. Like his contrary advice. You should read more books and only read books and don't watch movies. Okay, that's your filmmaking advice. Kat?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for your call.
Okay.
Have a grand evening.
Okay.
Kurt Vile.
Yo.
What's up?
Hey, what's your favorite, okay. You know, Werner Herzog, when he hears, that's actually kind of sad, but you saw Grizzly Man, I'm sure.
Yeah, I saw both Grizzly Man movies.
Oh, is there two?
Yeah.
Oh, is there like the making of
No, the there's soundtrack? One where they go back.
Okay.
It's called Grizzly Man 2, Hunt for a Grizzly.
I just think it's really intense, but like you almost wonder, is he acting? Probably not, but maybe a little bit. But he's like, pretend it was you who were the one with the tape. And he's like, Tom, you must never play this tape. You must never play this tape. Intense.
Yeah. I was watching. Hey, you know, the thing with him is sometimes when he thinks he's like super funny, like.
I know.
I was watching this one movie he did about the internet. And then, like, he was talking, but he's like. And then in the movie, it's. We show the monks. There are monks surfing the web. I was like, okay, yeah, it's not that fun. Like, he's saying it like it's the funniest thing he ever heard. And these monks, they. They have internet passwords, and they download different.
Yeah.
They download different songs from the internet, and you're just like, "Yeah, okay." And but he's saying it like it's literally the funniest thing that he's ever observed.
But yeah, Werner Herzog, king of comedy.
Yeah, that would be. I never saw the Bad Lieutenant movie he did. I should see that, right?
Is that a joke? He didn't do that.
He did Port of Call, New Orleans. Right, Mike? Yeah. Bad Lieutenant. There was a Bad Lieutenant sequel, which is not a sequel. Was it a sequel?
Wait, like...
Harvey Keitel's not in it. Nicolas Cage is in it.
He does real... Sorry. I don't mean to show my...
No. That's... Look. You shouldn't believe it. It sounds insane.
I thought he just did documentaries. Well, no, I know early on he did those crazy movies, but then yeah. I just thought he switched to... I didn't think he did modern movies.
He goes back and forth now. Okay. He goes back and forth. Port of Call, New Orleans.
The monks.
Would you watch it, Mike, if I get you that master class? Why don't we start getting free stuff like that?
Did you ever...
It drives me up the wall.
There's also like a list, supposedly he... Where he really rips into his maid. Did you ever see this letter?
No.
Werner Herzog. He just, it could be fake, but it was hot news for a second. He's like really ripping into the maid, how she, you could look it up. It's like this, he really, I guess just let's just say the house wasn't to his clean to his liking, to his anal retentive liking. If we could say that.
Yeah, we just did. Here it is, Werner Herzog's note to his cleaning lady. Yeah. Here we go. Rosalina, woman, you constantly revile me with your singular lack of vision. Is this real?
Yeah. I mean, it was real. I mean, it could be fake news.
Your money is under the guillotine. That's like how he signed it. This is great. Oh, my God.
It's right up your alley, I thought.
This is, oh, look. It is right up my alley, brother.
Thanks, brother.
Now, speaking of brother, Paul?
Yeah.
Because Kurt Vile, this guy, look, this guy's a straight-up rock star. This guy plays shows everywhere. Terminal 5 sells it out. He tours the world, this guy. What's it like when you just say, my brother is a rock star?
Well, I watched it from the beginning.
Yeah, no, I know you didn't meet him 4 years ago.
He loves it. He loves it. Just sit down.
Just come in and have a seat. Just have a seat, Paul. Because your name is Paul Vile, but you promote yourself as the Jell-O Man.
I think he's a new Jell-O Man. Though. He's not the old Jell-O Man.
There's something different. You're first of all, your fitness is you're so physically fit now that it's like you're just you are like a wall. You're like one of your own Mason recreations.
Do the walrus.
Yeah, like the walrus. You are your own masonry now. You have become the stone.
I can build you a patio.
Yeah, no, I know that.
Yeah.
We talked about this last time.
Yeah.
You notice I didn't follow up on that the last time we talked about it. I didn't reach out to be like, hey, that patio stuff you were. Oh, I know. Look, I don't need a patio.
But I was selling Jell-O shots before Kurt got a record label.
Oh, come on.
Before Mexican Summer.
Yeah.
Is that true?
Let's not give Mexican Summer the credit of the first record.
The first record was...
Well, actually, let's not give Rich the Records. First record credit at all.
Okay. All right.
But that's not what I... Sorry, I'm just getting sidetracked.
Sure.
The very first CD came out on a label that one day I'm going to sue the pants off of. And then I think the next one was Mexican Summer. Okay. So you're
yes. So...
Put it this way. I was really excited to sell Jell-O shots. And then all of a sudden... Kurt started going to the same festivals I was going to, and I couldn't believe it. I was like, super excited then. I was like, well,
so you were at these festivals, and then suddenly you're getting followed around by Kurt.
No, yeah.
Like, Kurt's just like looking at the Jell-O Man schedule.
No.
And then seeing if he can get on the bill.
I actually lost sales when he got his record label because then I started going with him, started cutting it into my like sell time, and I would just bring Jell-O shots to him and his... crew,
false.
And I would just give them Jell-O shots.
This is fabricated.
This is driving Kurt up the wall. I will say this though, Paul. You started selling Jell-O shots. You promote yourself as Jell-O Man. You do all sorts of other things. You got gumball machines. You've got masonry. You're a photographer now.
Come on.
Clearly a director or whatever, a cinematographer.
Clearly.
So you're doing a little bit of this, a little bit. Last time you were here, you showed your guitar playing and your singing, which was, well, hey.
Horrendous. I know. It was a funny memory.
I never listened to it again.
What's that?
Kurt told me not to listen to it again. He said, don't rewind it.
Don't rewind it.
You must have said it.
No, yeah. When I heard it the first time, I turned to you and I was like, Jell-O Man, you must... You must never play this tape.
Never. Do not rewind this.
Do not.
So. But one of the stories you told was that you were at a festival selling Jell-O shots. And Kurt was performing on the bill also.
Yeah.
And that.
Bootleg sunglasses?
Come on, not let him. Kurt is up there performing. and that he can't get a word in edgewise because the audience is just cheering.
Oh.
Jello man.
Thank God you said his story.
Jello man. Jello man.
It was a lot more than he said. There was one or two. It was like a huge part of the crowd. Because I was there like 3 days before them or 2 days.
Uh-huh.
And word got out that
it was a huge part of the crowd.
It was.
Okay, cool.
He forgot already.
It was a huge part of the crowd that shouted Jello Man once before I played.
Yeah, because I gave Kurt a guitar, everyone shouted my name.
That's Jello,
but they wanted Jello shots.
Jello Man.
Yeah.
Jello. And he was like, I'm trying to play songs.
I'm not saying I'm trying to, right? I'm not going to play songs. I'm going to give Jello shots.
No, I know that.
They were cheering for me.
But Kurt's on stage starting to play a song.
But I was giving him his guitars.
And then he can't even hear his own music in the monitor because it's just Jello Man. Jello,
no,
man.
It was when I was Jello. Handing it the guitar to him.
Right?
How did he get a guitar?
So you're handing him the guitar, and they see you come out. And
yeah,
they
dude, can you hand me to get a guitar?
They see you come out handing him the guitar.
Yeah.
Right? And then they start just chanting Jello, yeah. Man.
That's the whole story.
Dude,
the whole thing was you were like, how many people was it? And he was like, I don't know, like two. But I wasn't there to tell it was actually way more true. I remember thinking he's just totally downplaying it.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
Well.
You know what I'm saying?
I do know what you're saying. All right, Paul, get out.
Yeah. I know. We got Rob Schnapp, my friend in L.A., who recorded my song Pretty Pimpin'.
Eat that mic, bro. Eat that mic. Get up on that mic.
Okay.
There we go.
Rob Schnapp.
The guy who produced...
He did my Pretty Pimpin' song and others on my last record. And he's also a legend. He did, like, Beck's first record, which I love. Mellow mm-hmm. Gold. Elliot Smith. But anyway, you know, just like you, they're intrigued by Jello Man. They have the imitation of Jello Man.
Uh-huh.
Sort of like, get a guitar. It's like, this is Jello Man. To them, they're like, hey, what's up, dude? And he's like, blah,
he's like mumbling.
Because
he's like,
He's rapid fire. Yeah. It's like music when Jello Man talks.
Oh, it's the most beautiful symphony I've ever heard.
It's like, to me, it's just like jazz. When yeah. Jello Man talks, like boom, ba-dum, boom, ba-dum, yeah, right? Boom.
Those cats was really cooking.
And you hear Jello Man just like, wait, what going on? But just picture like, it's like just like somebody playing along. Boom, ba-dum, like.
Yeah, but like salt peanuts.
Yeah,
it's like salt peanuts. That's pure gold.
Best show.
Hello?
Yes, hi.
Hi. Calling out Bruno Mars.
You're calling about Bruno Mars. What, that he's going to be doing this second Labyrinth movie?
I hope not.
Why, you don't think that would be good?
No, because it sounds crazy, but I think I'm pretty sure he's a robot.
That Bruno Mars is a robot?
Not a robot, but you know, like a human robot. Not a human robot, but like a, what do you call it?
I don't know what you call it. He said he's like a robot, then he said, well, not a robot, a human robot, which is, what, an android?
Like on Aliens, like a...
Like the guy who had the thing burst out of his chest in Aliens?
Yes.
Yeah, that was a human.
Wait. Well, no.
Get off my face. Just drive me up the wall. So, Kurt, what's been going on?
Well, when I saw you last, I was going to Australia, and I played a solo tour of Australia, and it went pretty good.
And that was just you and your guitar.
Yeah, got a loop pedal. So if I chose to hit a loop, I would. I had a banjo. I had some guitars. No, that went good. That went awesome. Actually, I'm going to go. You're talking about Ocean City. I'm about to go to Ocean City. I got the little downtime with the family. I got a couple. I've been working on my solo album. Got a good amount of that going. I mean, you know, the band's in it too. But anyway, I also have another record that's going to come out before then. It's kind of a secret, but they're going to announce it soon. So can't tell you the second one.
A secret.
Yeah.
Is it you and Jello Man? Finally, the two of you together on wax.
I'm sure that'll happen eventually, but no, not yet.
Three lobed. Gonna put out the Kurt and Paul album.
He wishes.
Yeah, he's
dude. Really... Honestly, there's a kid, and he's a nice kid, but he's like people always get intrigued, just like you about the Jello Man. But somebody's like saying they're gonna do a documentary about Jello Man, but they're like, hey, I really love a little of your time, Kurt. Can you talk to me about Paul and Jello? It's like, and it's always like Paul and if you want to talk about Paul and Jello, I'm like, it's like, ah, oh, Paul is my brother. When I was a kid, I hated him. Now I like him the best. My favorite Jello is grape Jello. It's like, I love to talk about Paul and Jello constantly.
So. Yeah, so you're busy. You're laying down a lot of groundwork for the upcoming year plus.
Oh yeah,
I guess so. Are the songs coming easy for this next record?
I got a lot of songs, more coming all the time. I'm also working on a film score.
Really?
Yes.
Can you say what film that is?
I probably could, but I won't say the title just because. But there's a lot of interesting people in this movie that I'm excited about.
Like, a lot of,
and you're going to be proud of me, Tom.
In it, are there any Avengers?
It's kind of a dirty movie, but an artful dirty movie.
Mike, now stay out.
Whores on Zayth. I go to the whores on whatever avenue.
So you're doing a score.
Mm-hmm.
For a skin flick.
No, it's a cool movie. It's a cool
stag movie.
It's a cool movie, I think.
Okay. No, it's the rated R.
NC-17.
NCO, look out.
I don't
NC-17.
Know. NC-17. I don't know.
Well, I need to talk to my mommy then before I can see this.
No.
And that is, that's something that's been going on for a while?
It's pretty new.
And how are you finding that experience of thinking about music from that direction?
I'm actually been thinking about it for a while because when I'm jamming at home, I'm like working on pieces all the time,
mm-hmm.
like things here and there. I'm kind of working on little pieces all the time, and I'm more ADD than I used to be. So, like, I can't necessarily all put them all into a song, you know? Like, Waking on a Pretty Day, that's like kind of an epic song. That mm-hmm. era of mine, I was like... compiling all these pieces together or whatever, making it into a song. I prefer to just let the ideas just go into a movie instead. I don't know. I'm going to just work towards not going on the road unless I really want to, because it's a jungle out there, and the flights are way more turbulent now too. I don't know. I like almost have a panic attack every time.
Do you feel like Paul, your brother, could be? Couldn't you see him in some sort of video on a phone getting dragged off of a flight?
Oh, jeez.
Right? Just picture.
Yeah.
This is my seat. This is my seat. No, this is my seat. Oh, my Jello shots are in that seat. Yeah. Oh, my Jello shots.
I paid for a seat for these Jello shots.
No, the middle seat. I get the aisle seat. The Jello shots get the middle seat.
Yes.
Sir, we're going to need to put your Jello shots in the overhead compartment.
Sir. No, like, man, they'd live for that. Like, sir, I have to tag that guitar. They do that all the time. They live for somebody to be like, can't I just try to take it on the plane? Sir. And then they talk on the phone real quietly. It just happened the other day. Like, sir, you leave that there. And they're like, blah, 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 blah. It's like they're calling. Like,
and they just
we got a live one here.
Like, yeah, they're like, looking for the,
sir,
the showdown.
Yeah, they love it.
Paul wouldn't bring the Jello shots on the plane. He'd bring the components on, and then he would get yelled at for making Jello. He'd have the packets.
Yeah,
and they'd be stirring, And they'd be like, sir, you can't make Jell-O on the plane.
Well, bring the grease. I got the stuff, brother.
Yeah.
Hey, bro. Hey, brother. Look, I'm making Jell-O shots up in here in the stratosphere. I'm making them in the ionosphere.
Yeah.
Time out. Macho Man's prerogative.
Now.
Yes.
Steve, is Steve here tonight?
Yeah.
Mike?
Yeah.
Can you tell Dudio to ask Pat to show Steve to the studio, please? Oh, no, that's Pat. Oh, there it is. I thought it was
hey!
Like...
Oh, there it is. I couldn't find it.
No, you found it.
God, it's gone all, went all these other rooms.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Steve Gunn, finally.
Hello.
The other pride of Philadelphia. What are you guys eating out there?
Popcorn.
Do you guys want to order pizza?
Oh.
Do people want pizza?
Can you order one that has no cheese on it? I know that's weird.
Yeah, no, we can. Why don't you get a pizza order together?
Okay.
Would you? And let me see. And look, Mike, I'm going to get pineapple on half of one. I don't want to hear that pee. That's not pizza. Yeah, no, I could spot your handwriting. I knew who wrote those notes last week within 5 seconds. Because we did a thing last week. It was, we did a complaint box. And where it was anonymous and they were dropped into a hat. I could figure out whose handwriting everything was this within guy. 5 seconds.
Whoa.
Whoa. Look at this guy.
He's on lifestyle.
This guy can't handle it. This, gentleman, it wasn't paying attention to him. He sticks his head in the door.
Dude. What's up? Hey, brother. You guys still doing the show in there? Show still going on?
He was just locked out. He's tapping on the window.
He does not like.
Man, this Mike Love action card is mind-blowing.
Is he the one?
Someone sent Beach Boys trading cards.
Did you see the photo?
I saw that, you know, there's a Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous of Mike Love.
Oh,
actually, my buddy.
Yeah.
Did you ever see that?
Yes.
Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous, Mike Love. Where's the love, Mike Love? He's always saying some corny pun or trying.
Robin Leach.
Whoever the heck he is.
Well, he wrote that big autobiography.
Did he?
Yeah, I read that.
Oh, you read it?
Yeah.
Whoa.
It came out over the... It came out like in like September. Because when I read that, I was going to Las Vegas where I saw a Criss Angel benefit concert. And who was at it? Robin Leach. And I have filmed Robin Leach. Yeah.
Okay.
Now, I filmed him for 2 minutes, standing perfectly still, looking at his cell phone. It's one of the greatest things ever filmed. I've yet to release it to the public.
What was he wearing?
He was wearing, that's a great question, Steve.
Okay.
And he was wearing a kind of like a Miami Vice style suit.
Wait, he was alone as well?
There were other people milling about, but he was, and then he had this like sloppy, like Hanes white t-shirt on underneath the Miami. It was like the strangest thing where he had this like breezy kind of Miami Vice style look, and then just with like a t-shirt that really looked like he escaped from a hospital.
Yeah.
On Twitter, somebody saying Kurt does pretty good impressions.
Yeah, dude.
Robin Leach, Neil Young.
Yeah, well, I didn't do Neil Young yet.
No.
Thank you.
Who can you do it? Let's hear it.
Okay, well, Robin Leach, I love his one-liners. He's like, tennis anyone? Or like, he's like, looking to get away? I don't know. I can't really do it right now. He's like, how about getting on this helicopter?
Now, what would it be like, Kurt, if Neil Young was talking to Hulk Hogan? How would that go?
He's like, all right.
Hey, brother. Hey, brother. I really loved Heart of Gold tonight.
He's like,
Oh, man, I can't do two at once. It's advanced.
I can do Hulk.
Okay, you do Hulk.
Okay.
Hey, brother, what do you want for Christmas?
Oh, listen, Hulk. Just get out of my face. I'm just trying to concentrate on the music. All I care about is the music. It's sad, but it's true.
I respect that, brother.
Yeah. Okay, now Randy Macho Man Savage comes in. And they're talking, I'll be Macho Man. So.
Don't even remind me of Neil Young.
Macho Man here with Hulk Hogan and got Neil Young here. I got my pono. Neil, what's on my pono?
Funny that you should ask. I can't do this. There's
do
too many
it.
People. All right.
It's funny.
All right.
Oh, yeah. What's going on my pono?
Listen, Macho. I can't. I'm combining people. No, listen. I met him for the fourth time the other day, and I just always say the same thing. All I had to do was be like, Neil, just yesterday at Stagecoach, I played with your buddies, the Sadies. And he'd be like, oh, the Sadies.
Yeah.
Oh, I love Travis. I love the Sadies. But instead I'm like, Neil, I love you. And he's like, he stops looking at me. He was with Daryl Hannah and everything.
Yeah. Whoa. But look, you should be jamming with this dude. Both of you guys should.
Well, next time I got to just be a little less eager.
Yeah.
Where was this?
This was at Stagecoach. And I went the day before. I was jamming with my buddy, the Sadies, who are incredible. And I sang a song with them. And then the next day, I went to see Willie Nelson, and he turned 83 or 84 on stage. And I'm buddies with a little bit with his son, Lucas Nelson. It's like that. All everything's right there in front of me. And then Neil Young, he got on stage like with a birthday cake at the very last song, played harmonica. And he had his old-fashioned car, and he was there with Daryl Hannah, like just waiting behind the bus. And all I had to be was like, Neil, I play with the Sadies. Oh, yeah, the Sadies. Kurt, I remember you. How's it going? But instead I'm like, I met you a couple times. I'm friends with so-and-so. I love you!
And then they
immediately just don't. At first he shakes your hand. He's like, oh, yeah. And then you're like, love you, bro. And then he just looks away. They're like standing right in front of you, but their eyes are just looking the other way.
Yeah.
Because I'm a fanboy. But, you know, one day.
Now, Steve.
Yes.
Steve Gunn. You are a rock star also.
Mm.
You're on true. Matador Records also.
Yeah.
You had a record last year, true or false? You had a record
true.
Come out last year.
True.
And that record was called Eyes on the...
Lines.
Eyes on the Lines. And that is a great record.
Thank you.
I love that record so much. And for people who don't know Steve Gunn, how do we describe... The stylings of Steve Gunn. We've played before on the show. I can't always play things on Matador here due to some situational things. Not anything having to do with Matador, but we're sorting those things out.
What?
Good.
Don't worry. Everything's getting figured out.
Sounds juicy. Tennis anyone?
So, because it's so funny when people think of Philly, right? Mm. They think of Philadelphia. Now, did you grow up in Philadelphia?
I grew up in Philly.
You grew up in Philly.
I don't live there anymore, but...
Okay. But when you were there... So yes. I always keep thinking everybody goes to Philly and never leaves Philly.
Yeah.
That's the thing with me. I don't know. Yes. Yeah, you're in New York.
I'm in New York.
Yes.
But I grew up in Philly.
But you grew up in Philly.
Mm-hmm. I grew up in the western suburbs of Philly.
Okay.
A town called Lansdowne. Which is a small suburb.
Mm-hmm.
It's close to Upper Darby.
Okay,
It's one of the first suburbs kind of, you know, just outside of the city limits.
Upper Darby, home of?
Todd Rundgren.
And?
My mom.
And? You can say it. Tina Fey.
Oh, Tina Fey.
Oh, yeah.
Mm.
That's right. Todd Rundgren.
My mom went to high school with him.
Really?
Upper Darby High, yeah. She told me his nickname was Dirtbag.
Dirtbag. So, like, she'd be like, yeah, there was this guy, Dirtbag, who was in this band.
I basically said, Mom, Do you remember this guy named Todd Rundgren? Of course, yeah. I mean, she sort of knew. She knew who he was. But she said that people called him Dirtbag.
Did your mom see the Naz back then?
I wish, no. No. She was more into... She did see a lot of cool, like, Motown artists.
Okay.
You know, there was American Bandstand and all that stuff down there.
Out of Philly, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. So she's... Her and my dad saw a lot of really cool, you know, early, like, early Stevie Wonder concerts and all that stuff. But no, like, sort of... I mean, the Naz were pretty obscure.
Yes.
And Mandrake Memorial was another one.
Mm-hmm.
But they didn't... I don't think they...
So they weren't seeing, like, Temple of Bon Matin later?
No, my mom was super into them.
Like, she really into, like, the all the Silpry stuff?
Like, Brother JT and Vibralux?
Sure.
She went wild for them.
Brother JT.
That was... I must say, I actually was speaking on this before. That's one of the most underrated Philly bands. Past.
Who's that?
Brother JT and Vibralux.
He's got, like, this lifetime of...
But did you ever see that incarnation?
No.
Oh, they were really good. It was really? A bigger band.
Okay.
And he was, you know, kind of let loose and took his clothes off. And
I would have remembered.
It was memorable experience for me, for sure.
Is it strange when you think about how people think of Philly, and then there's this tradition in Philly of just, like, weirdo stuff.
Uh-huh.
Out of Philly. It's like as much a city for weirdos as any.
Definitely.
And I mean that, obviously, no. I mean in the most positive way.
Yeah, of course.
But it's like such a haven for people to do things kind of off the grid a little bit.
The Sunar Orchestra, for instance.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they have been living there since the 60s.
Yeah, and then for all the stuff, all the rock stuff and all the noisy stuff and all the Silpry stuff. And then what you guys are all doing, for that to just kind of happen off the, kind of on its own, very organically.
Yeah.
It's kind of as much what Philadelphia's about as anything.
Yeah, for sure.
So when you started, you're a young boy.
Young boy.
You get a guitar.
Got a guitar.
You carry it in what now, a gunny sack?
In a,
just like Chuck Berry? A gunny sack? Like Chuck Berry.
I got it. It was like a cloth bag. You know how you got that, like, Christmas special?
Like a gig bag.
Yeah. I was lucky enough to have an older sister who had really good taste in music. So I was kind of sneaking into her room and taking her cassettes and listening to her, like, mixes and all that stuff. And she had all these cool friends that I admired from a short distance.
And what were the things that you were just like, this is the thing that I love that she doesn't love? Right now.
Oh, for me?
The thing where you owned your own...
When I started listening to really kind of like three-chord, really like formulaic, like bonehead hardcore music.
Okay.
You know, kind of stuff from Jersey, Connecticut, you know, bands that were... I quickly grew out of it, but I kind of started going to more local shows, and then my friend and I... We were into, like, skateboarding and stuff, and we got into these local kind of punk bands, and then we got into kind of DIY hardcore scene and ordering 7-inches in the mail and, you know, going not too far, but, you know, maybe to Connecticut or these festivals around, you know.
And so if that's the hardcore stuff is the foundational stuff,
yeah.
when does the other stuff come in, the quiet
stuff? Oh, the quiet stuff.
Or just the stuff that leads you to where you are now.
Okay,
textured stuff.
I went to Temple University.
Sure.
And they had an awesome... Well, you know, also, I must say that, you know, another thing about Philly that's great is they have great record stores.
Yes.
You know, back when I was in high school, there was a store called Third Street Rock and Jazz.
Mm-hmm.
And I had a friend who was a bit older who worked there. And then, of course, Record Exchange was like this institution that... I started going to when I was 15, 16, and those guys were always so cool, and they had these weird posters, like Sun City Girl posters, like, what the hell is that? You know,
those kinds
of, like, weird discoveries, and those guys were always so open-minded, like, yeah, check this out, blah, 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 you know. And also, Temple had such cool radio programming, and also Drexel, like WKDU, and Temple had jazz stuff, so I kind of just, like, listened to the radio a lot and discovered all this stuff pretty quickly.
You were head first.
Head first, exactly. Yeah.
Now, which vial did you meet first, Paul or Kurt?
What do you think?
This is how I pictured going down. And look, correct me.
Go ahead.
Exterior. Philadelphia playground day.
Playground.
We did go to the same grade school, but we didn't really meet until...
Steve Gunn.
Huh? Oh, sorry. I'm sorry.
Walks onto the playground holding a guitar. An RV pulls up.
Yeah.
And a young muscled man lowers a 6-foot-high gumball machine out of it and starts lifting it over and over, doing reps with the gumball machine. Steve, who are you? Young man.
Yeah.
Salt peanuts.
Salt peanuts. So you meet Kurt first, I'm going to assume, over Paul.
Yep.
Sorry, Paul. I tried.
I have an interesting story of the first time I kind of hung out with Paul.
Okay.
Can I quickly just mention
that? Yeah. Yeah.
Am I getting off the track?
No, there is no track.
Okay.
I'm surprised the door just didn't open.
There's never a track.
What's the story? What's the story?
I was at a festival in Austin.
Okay.
And you guys were there, or I don't even remember if you were there, but Jell-O Man was there. And I was with a few other friends, and he had this whole... I hope he doesn't get upset about telling the story. Probably won't. But no, it's not bad. It's not bad. But anyway, there was he had this awesome tent set up, and he was playing music and all these people hanging around, like his whole like
harem.
Groupie friends and all that stuff.
Harem.
And he was like, and we were hanging out, and he's like,
uh-huh.
And so he had the van with the screen printing stuff, and the Jell-O Shot factory was in the van, and he's like, listen, man, this girl over here, she was about 20 feet away. She tripping on acid, and she stole my keys. So basically this girl stole his van keys. But she was still kind of hanging out.
Mm-hmm.
And he's like, what do you think? And I was like, it's possible, yeah. And we kind of walked over there and like peeked around in her tent. And she just was playing it so cool.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, dude, I think she had your keys, man. But we couldn't like help him figure the whole thing out. And apparently he had
tackle
to...
her.
He had to...
tackle her.
Apparently he had to get somebody to come make him a key for his van.
Really?
And she did
just get it from
but
her?
She did have the key, yeah. Right?
Come on in, Paul.
It was like, you ever see that Helen Hunt? Like when the first
thing
Helen Hunt did?
Did I get that right? Okay.
Was like an after school drug special.
Yeah.
She's like, he's like, it's just a little angel dust.
And then she like jumped out a window.
Yeah.
Is that true, Paul? Is that how it went down? Yeah. Take that mic. You can take that mic.
Yeah. Get your own.
Exactly how it went down.
All right. Okay. Well, thanks for coming in.
No. It's funny. Steve came over. We were hanging out. This girl, she came over. She was all nice at first.
Mm.
Apparently, she took some acid reflux medicine. I mean,
that's better.
She took acid.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Anyway, she'd been started getting all dissonant and weird, blah, blah, blah.
Dissonant?
Distant.
Okay.
I saw, this is why I say it.
Distant,
like I'm going crazy because I had a hiding place for my key. I put it like in a certain like corner under my tent, like outside the tent. Like I obviously was reaching under my tent and I saw her look right at me. I saw her look at it and then look up at me. And I'm thinking like, why would she want my key?
Why would she want the key?
That's what I'm saying.
It's
so,
like a rat. She likes shiny things.
She'd have to walk so far to get to my van way over there. She would never have any use for this key right now. But apparently, she was...
I'm listening.
Oh. They were going to face at me.
No.
Apparently, she like started really tripping hard. And then she was like... We were probably all aggressive up talking about like selling stuff.
Like, oh, like, that's...
And she's probably just getting all like bugged out by how aggressive we were talking about like making money. Like
what?
From Jell-O shots and
that's,
t-shirts.
Yeah, but you
talking about making money.
No, Steve wasn't there. Sunglasses. Steve wasn't there for that whole interaction.
Now, can I just ask as a sidebar? Have you ever bootlegged any Steve Gunn shirts or sunglasses.
No, I would never do that.
You'd just do it with your family.
I bootleg Kurt, yeah.
You'd only bootleg a family member's name likeness.
The bootleg series.
I mean, that's what I'm saying. The whole bootleg thing is where I came from, but
bootleg thing is where I came from.
I'm saying, like, that's why I started. I had no, like, mercy. I just, like, just go out and sell anywhere.
Yeah.
But now I'm starting to meet people that own, that started something, and, like, they own, and all of a sudden I feel bad. I can't just go bootleg Steve Gunn.
You could if you want.
I feel bad he started something.
What are you going to do when you look? Irony of ironies.
When someone bootlegs me?
Yeah. Well, we could have let me get there.
Okay, go ahead.
No, you did it already. You took
some bootlegs me.
This is a race. It's a race here. You got to the, don't worry, you got to the finish line. Now, yeah. How would you feel? You see somebody with a shirt that just says Jell-O Man. And you're like, I don't recognize that shirt.
I would like that for a while, I think.
Yeah, but then what if you saw another one?
Okay.
That's what if somebody's taking money? That's the problem.
And then suddenly yours aren't selling so much.
So I'm saying, am I that level, I guess? And yeah. Who the hell would bootleg a Yellow Man shirt?
But then, okay, then imagine this now.
I'm not that level, I guess.
Dr. Dog are playing, right? And then you see a guy making a sign out of Jell-O shots that says Dr. Dog.
Oh, that pissed me off.
That would bother you, right?
Yes. That's Jell-O art.
Okay, well, that's Jell-O art. Somebody's doing Jell-O art.
That's a problem.
Got to copyright it, don't I?
You wouldn't like that, would you?
Mm-mm.
How much money, and look, the past is the past. Right. We don't worry about that. I'm not worried about it. Kurt's not worried about it. Mm-hmm. Steve's not worried about it. How much money do you think you made off of Kurt Vile merchandise that you bootlegged?
$5,000.
No, I don't think so.
You think $5,000 that you've like you pulled $5,000 from sunglasses, shirts?
I doubt it.
Over $5,000.
I doubt it. Nobody's gonna sit and buy some bootleg Kurt Vile stuff in general anyway.
Is the thing?
BS.
They're married together with Jell-O shots.
My favorite thing is I told Brian Schwartz.
Who's to say I'm not? They're not just liking the Jell-O shots and they want to buy the shades. Because I already interacted with them and I got the connection with the Jell-O shots.
Sure.
So who's to say that they would have bought Kurt?
Okay, well, here's one then.
So dumb.
How many people do you feel became fans of Kurt's music through the Jell-O shots?
No, believe it or not, I can give you a real answer for that.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Probably none.
None.
I'm saying, like, when I go to the festivals, the ones I mainly go to don't know Kurt because I go to, like, jam band festivals or, like, electronic music.
Yeah.
Like, sometimes I feel dumb even saying, like, why would I bring his name up? Mm-hmm. Unless we started conversating and they asked me about, like, what I'm doing or blah, blah. But, like, if I were just like, oh, I'm Kurt Vile's brother, it sounds stupid. I don't even know who he is sometimes.
But what if it's a show?
You definitely do that.
No. I'm saying sometimes at the ones like at, like, a Sasquatch. Yeah,
what if
sure.
What if it's a show he's – and speaking of Sasquatch, I just want to honor – the one-year anniversary of one of the worst days of my life, which was performing at Sasquatch and flaming out as hard as I've ever flamed out in any endeavor I've ever been a part of.
That makes me sad that you feel that way. Because I remember I was going to say something, but like you're probably like, Jell-O Man, shut up.
Yeah.
Because why would I know more than what you experienced?
You know one of the great moments?
But you're in the middle.
Well, here's a great moment. Meet Shannon and the Clams, a band I really like a lot. And then, like, hey, you know, we're about to go on and do this thing and stuff. And they're like, oh, you know, we know Terry T and all the stuff they had played on Terry T's show. And then when I'm on stage watching Shannon and the Clams leave the tent 10 minutes in, because that's how poorly it's going. Just watching them just seeing them walk out, like, specifically, like... Yeah, we don't
maybe
want.
They had
this is the thing,
press.
Though, Tom. You understand?
Maybe they had to be a press.
Oh, I'm sure that's what it is. It was a press. That's why they went in the direction. They just went out.
Did you? You were at that moment, were you visibly frustrated? Like, this sucks? Or were you trying to?
Oh no, it was nuts. We just doubled down on having fun for ourselves, because it was so stacked against us the entire event.
Was there other bands playing? Was it that problem?
Oh, well, Savages were playing 300 feet away, which is, it's always great for comedy, right? When two people are talking on stage and then meanwhile you have a band blasting.
I saw Savages, the singer, and they're nice kids, but she was like, how was the sound? How would you like it? Louder, faster? We'll see what we can do.
But Tom, I remember walking down to your show, like, and I was like, even just me physically before I even got there, it was just hot there, and like, it's the middle of the day, and people were just kind of like,
that's why.
I'm telling you.
It's, oh, that's what it, no.
It was 100%. It was the heat. Some people go there for just a shelter to hang out under there.
Oh, I know that.
And it's peaceful there.
Yeah.
Because it's not like blasting music, and you took it all personal. I'm just telling you.
No, you want to know what? I flew across the country to do it.
Well,
could have stayed home. Could have read a comic book.
But you powered through it. Was it an hour?
Flew across the country.
Hour?
You don't want to. Did you see me out there?
45 minutes.
Did you even see me once out there?
No, I didn't see.
I was trying to. I was going like this.
That's what Paul says constantly.
I wish I saw
you. Did you even see me once out there?
I would have brought you up on stage. So, Paul.
Yeah.
Where do people find your masonry business? I want people in the greater Philadelphia area. If they're in the market for a Millennium Falcon patio,
Instagram for this time period. If you're going to, you know, Instagram or Facebook.
And you're on Instagram as what now?
Gentleman Philly. I just did a patio for Kurt, and he made me work on Easter. He called me.
I made you work.
He called me a week before, and I finished it up.
You love it.
You love
it. You love to work.
So you worked on Easter.
He told me
Easter, like
he was coming back from Stagecoach.
So special.
He was coming back from Stagecoach, and he was like, "Or he was at Stagecoach." He's like, "Just so you know, I need this patio done for Wilda's birthday, his daughter."
Yeah.
And that was in a week. I was like, "Well, I guess I'll have to work Easter." He's like, "Well, then work Easter." So I do it.
That's right. I said, "Then work Easter," and he did it.
Then my other sister was like, she hit me up on Easter. She was like, "Are you coming?" I was like, "I'm working on Kurt's patio." She's like, "That's sad."
So on the day that he rose, our whole family's like, "Well, you're working on the day that he rose again from the dead."
What I'm gonna do now is close my eyes.
I'm gonna leave.
No. Can you do? I want to see who can do an impression the Vile Brothers of each other.
Ooh.
And I don't know who's who.
I got two impressions, but they're not me.
Are you asking me to do an impression, or are you asking me to imagine an impression?
Can you do an impression of Kurt?
Go for it. I dare you.
I'm closing my eyes.
Nah, it won't work that way.
Okay, I'll do it.
I mean,
do it.
I'm telling you, it just doesn't like register. I'm just used to Kurt making fun of me, so it's just like
I'm giving you the platform to make fun of him back.
Yeah.
I don't practice enough, though.
Give him go out there then and practice.
Yeah,
You and Mike write a routine then. Write a skit.
Is that your way of getting rid of me? Okay.
Kinda, yeah. Now I noticed.
I like this.
Steve Gunn, Matador recording superstar.
Yeah.
What did you had an album last year?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
What's coming next?
I'm working on a new album, actually, this week. I've been working on it.
Because you tour all over the place also.
Yeah.
You're out a lot of times solo yourself.
I did a solo tour in Europe. I've been back for a couple weeks.
Because I look and I see it's you and it's Lee Ronaldo.
Did some traveling with him, yeah.
How's he? All right?
He's good. Yeah, he's doing well. He's also traveling all over the place all the time.
Are you buddies with Lee at all?
Yeah, Lee's great. Super, super nice guy.
I don't know anyone anymore.
That's not true, Tom.
It's not true. I know exactly. AP Mike. I know you. And now I know Steve. Now
and Jello, of course.
Don't and, be, of course, Jello,
don't
man.
Don't be like that.
Who else do I know? Who?
Who else do you know?
Like famous.
Well, I don't know, Wild Flag? All the nice people in Wild Flag, Carrie Brownstein.
Yeah, I'm always hanging out with Wild
Flag. Nobody's always hanging out with anybody. I wish I could always hang out with you.
You can hang out with me. You're finally home. Let's go to the movies.
We were gonna see Kris Kristofferson, but instead I decided to go to Stagecoach just to like get, you know, belittled again by Neil Young.
Yeah. You could have gotten belittled anew by you? Chris Christopherson.
Well,
you'd go up to him, you'd be like,
"Can you retell that story how they was swamped by autographs or something?" And then all of a sudden, finally, he just got scared. Was he like, "Folks, I gotta go.
I gotta get out of here." He's 80. Yeah, I saw him in January or February. He's in Tarrytown. He's 81.
Uh-huh.
And it was just him with a guitar and a harmonica, a little harmonica clampy, bracy thing. And he's playing songs. He's playing all the songs. He played every hit he ever wrote. It's the greatest thing. Just all by himself up there. But not a lot of between song banter. I think that's maybe where he knows it. Just like, stick to the songs.
Yeah. He sounded good?
He sounded really good. Couple spots where he couldn't reach it, but he would acknowledge it and laugh about it. Like, he knows. And everybody, that's like a love fest for him. Because it's like, sure, there's a guy who, by all rights, in American history, Bill Clinton never should have happened. Chris Christopherson should have been Bill Clinton.
Mm. Wow.
Wow.
Military record. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Air Force. Rhodes Scholar.
Yeah, he landed his helicopter in Johnny Cash's backyard just to impress him a little bit.
Yeah, but he had...
And it worked.
But he had all the stuff, but then he goes and writes songs.
Mm.
He should have been president.
Damn it.
Mrs. Martha, middle class is really in a stew.
He would do that in the White. He'd play his own inauguration.
And what was that movie, The Putney Swope? Was that the one?
How about A Star Is Born? What about that movie? Have you seen that one?
With Barbara Streisand?
Oh, yeah.
Not in a long time.
Charmed, I'm sure.
I didn't see Putney Swope. That's the one directed by Robert Downey.
Yep.
Senior.
And I think Christopherson plays main character.
He's also
if I remember correctly. Maybe I'm wrong.
Mike?
But...
Is that true? Putney Swope? Mike's not a fan.
Okay.
He's also in Big Top Pee Wee.
Is he really?
Yeah, he's married to the tiny lady. He's like the circus major. Mm-hmm. Is that what it
is? So, this Chris Christopherson show, he's playing all the songs. And I bought a single ticket to it. Again, I'll go to a thing by myself. I don't care.
Tarrytown?
Tarrytown, yeah.
Was it in like kind of a...
It's a nice old theater. Cool. Tarrytown. Okay. This theater that's been there forever.
Okay.
I go to buy a ticket. I get the single seat. I'm front row center. Like, he's like 8 feet away from me.
Wow.
And now I'm scared the whole time to take a picture of him. Because my picture is just like, he's not looking at him. The one time he'll look down is when I have my thing.
He's going to catch it.
Come on, don't take pictures. We're trying to play the show. Put your phone away for once in your life. Like, I'll get a lecture about phones and stuff where it's like, trust me, I don't have my phone out all the time. Mr. Christopherson. So then, at the end of the show, he gets like punished for being so accessible. The crowd swells forward, and then people are like holding things for him to sign and stuff. No. And like, he's got his guitar still on him.
He's got nobody backing him up. Like,
Nobody. Wow. So then he's trying to be a nice guy. He like shakes a hand and then like signs some guy's like framed thing that just like, and then this is now for these vultures. It's open season on, they're trying to get as much out of Chris Christopherson.
Once that 10
feet between him being on and off the stage.
Once that caps off the Sharpie, then.
Yeah. So this girl took her phone and she's trying to do a selfie. Ooh. And he's like bending over trying to like get into the thing and she still can't get it right. It's like, this guy's 81 years old. You make him bend over. And finally, he's like, I gotta get out of here. He finally just stuck up for himself. He just played for an hour and 40 minutes for everybody. He's 81.
Oh, my God.
Folks, I gotta go.
Wow.
So, I notice you guys have your respective guitars.
Oh, yeah. Mm.
Maybe we could get some music going. What do you think about that?
For sure.
Who wants to play stuff first? Anybody? What do you guys want to do? What do you tell me what you want to do?
Know.
It's your show, not mine.
Well, Steve, I'll tell you, slays the guitar. So maybe I should open up for him.
Yeah, you should.
Okay.
All right, I'll open up
so for you. So you open up.
We want to play one song or two?
You play two songs.
All right, cool. Because that's what I got planned.
And
folks, wait a minute. Folks, I got to get my guitar. What?
So there's a Jello Man making eye contact with the tripping girl while he's hiding
his keys
under his tent and remembering it.
What is that?
I don't know. People are...
Here's your guitar.
People are thrilling.
Oh, thanks. You know what else? Strangely enough, can you also hand me that tote bag that has a picture of me inside a hoagie?
That's the Pat Cooper design. Done by Philly's own Perry Shawl.
Who wanted to come here.
He can come. He got a tattoo.
Yeah.
Especially he's in Hound.
Oh, and one more thing. Could somebody hand me one Colorado Kool-Aid as well?
Mike? Yeah. Mamacita?
Yeah.
Mamacita, would you get my guest, Kurt, a Colorado Kool-Aid, please, Mamacita?
Did you ever hear that song? I told you, listen to it. It's a good song. Johnny Paycheck. That's who.
Did you guys order pizza?
I was just about to.
All right, let's get that pizza order in.
Yeah, come on in.
Perry, come see Elvis. Okay, he's playing with Elvis Costello.
Who is? Perry Shaw?
Perry Shaw.
What?
What is he in the attractions now?
I don't get it. He's doing artwork for Dan Auerbach's. Auerbach!
Auer. Dan Auerbach!
Get it? Our back.
So I'm going to the Black Keys show.
I did bring that up to like, Our Back.
And I'm like, and then.
Get it.
Then like, then Our Back is like, I thought you'd want me to play something from my new album.
Our Back. Then Our Back. Get it. No. Where's my pick? Somebody get my purple pick. Oh, I can't hear me.
Where's that?
What happened?
Where's that?
You got it? Yeah, find me a purple pick now.
I love how Paul, it's the funniest thing. You revel in shoving him around a little bit. Now, what do you call the harmonica thing there? A brace?
Harmonica holder.
A harmonica holder.
Yeah, that's what Bob Dylan called it, too. By the way, are you a fan of... I can't really hear myself anymore. Did somebody take me away? Oh, thanks.
Do you want me to get up?
No, not yet.
No. Tom, you can't get up.
You hear?
Check. My voice is gone. I mean, check. I mean, I guess it's there, but it...
I want to say we're in studio. We have Kurt Viles here and Steve Gunn is here. And you can get any of their music over at Matador Records.
Check. Yeah, something low about my voice going on here.
I mean, this is lower now than it was.
Check. Oh, yeah. I'm deaf. Let me just tell you right now, but that's great. Thanks.
Let me just say this. We have an hour to go on the show. I want to say this to my friends in Chicago.
What?
My friends in Chicago... Let me just find this thing. I have to do this now. I got the...
Get it!
Show's getting away from me. Show's getting away from me. It always does.
Glamorous nymph with an arrow and boom.
Where is it? You know, there's the fest is going on now. The comedy thing. Where'd this email go? I got a pair of tickets to give away. Here it is. I can give away a pair of tickets tomorrow night. If you are in Chicago, the AV Club Festival is going on now. You can find out about all the shows at 26comedy.com. I have a pair of tickets to give away for two different shows this throughout this festival. One is for tomorrow night, May 31st, at the Music Box Theater in Chicago. The 4th annual 26th annual Comedy Festival presents Christopher Guest. It's a discussion with Christopher Guest and Robert Milazzo. And I have a pair of tickets to give away for that. If you are from Chicago, tweet at me. Say, I want the tickets. Say, I want Christopher Guest tickets. You have as many characters left in one tweet to write something to make it so I should give you the tickets. Tomorrow night or Saturday, June 3rd at the Athenaeum Theater in Chicago. Nathan For You, Season 4 Sneak Peek, and a Q&A with Nathan Fielder. So I have a pair of tickets for tomorrow night, Christopher Guest in conversation, or Saturday night, June 3rd, a sneak peek at Nathan For You, Season 4, with Nathan Fielder, doing a Q&A. And you can find out about either of those shows and all the other shows at 26comedy.com. But tweet at me whether you want the Nathan Fielder tickets or the Christopher Guest tickets. You've got to be able to use them in Chicago. Tweet at me and charm me. And I will pick a winner at the end of the show for both of those tickets.
Let's put another shrimp on the barbie.
Alright, I'm going to play a song from the first album when I was first on your show. It's the title track of the album that came out when I was first on your show. Just to take you back. Smoke ring for my halo, human angel demon, underestimated, right under the roof of your house. Thought you could see it then, yeah. Thought you could see it then, yeah. Thought you could see it then, yeah. See it there, yeah, yeah, yeah. That's for the next song, actually. Soda can, exercise my hand, pacifies the land, makes the most out of your chill time, man. I feel like laying down, wow,
I feel like laying down. Wow. Yeah, and I wanna do it again. Oh, what a mess I guess I'm in. Woo!
Okay, thanks.
All right.
Second.
Gentleman's filming.
Yeah.
Got a good angle there?
Paul, you getting all this? Paul, you getting all this as usual?
Yeah, why?
It's like from both sides. You getting all this as usual? Yeah, why? All right, I got a special song. It's an oldie that I added some new lyrics to. This is a real old song, and I added some new lyrics to it. Ready? Yeah. The song's called Blue Cheese. You ready?
Yeah.
All right. Chinese rock and roll, blue cheese up here, well you know, and I'm busting out of my seams, if you know what I mean, because I'm getting old. I didn't mean to cough on her. Forgot to add the fabric softener. I met a girl named Tina. That girl supplies the reefer-ina. So kiss me. Grown these agonizing eyeballs, hanging up on all the courtesy calls and creaming in my chicken game genie. A million laughs, never gonna die again. All right. Ridiculous oldie.
That's awesome. And what? That's Blue Cheese.
Yeah, it's a really old oldie, but it's just a silly song. But I had to put you in there, Tom.
Oh, thank you, Kurt.
I was thinking about you when I finished that song.
See that, Mike? Guy puts me in the song.
We put the kid stays in the picture.
That's the most flattering thing I've ever heard in my life.
Yeah.
No, I'll field this one. No, you can't. Now, they're going to put you. The only song you'll be in the thing, it'll be like a Bob Dylan, like Hurricane.
Dude, that's... Phone.
This is the story of AP Mike.
Yeah, you know...
Right?
You know
oh, that, my, we should do that.
You know
right?
that album... Dude, you know the song Sarah, where he tried to get back with his wife, Sarah? Yeah. Or he did for a second. But, you know, the rhymes are so weird.
Uh-huh.
And that one, like, he's like, there was nothing on the beach except for some kelp. And then he's like, I knew you were there when I needed your help. You know, just to rhyme, he rhymes kelp with help.
Yeah, that's...
I actually, for that song, I have one extra verse. It's just as ridiculous. You ready? He's like, there was nothing on the beach except for some seals, two or three walrus and a beach humpback whale. I pushed him back in. He thanked me with his spout. I've always been one with the sea creatures. I've always had clout. Sarah, Sarah, glamorous nymph with an arrow and bow. Don't ever go.
I'm going to say this, though. That look, that's... Maybe
look,
Neil,
that is stupid.
Neil can get that to Bob.
No, right? I'll get it to Bob. Well, okay, Neil might. Neil?
Mike, what would you think about... at apmike.bandcamp.com, which is this dumb
which is this website dumb
that Mike always has his stuff at. All right, calm down. Don't. What are you, Jell-O man? Like,
relax.
He's my Jell-O man. He's my Jell-O man. Mike is my Jell-O man. Hey, you want me to build you a deck? Like Jell-O man will do. He'll do some mason work. Mike builds decks for people.
Does he?
And outdoor pools.
Does he?
Yeah, he builds above ground pools.
But Paul's like out and threatened.
Yeah.
Well, does
he? Hey, Mike. Mike, you want to go to business?
Yeah, what do you want to do, gentlemen?
I'll build the deck. Then you build the above ground pool.
Bricks are off a little bit. Festival season is here.
Okay. So the all right. I love when you get so literal with things.
Well, it's actually festival season now. We're not doing masonry right now.
It's like, all right, yeah, no.
We're actually not doing masonry right now. Festival season's here.
I guess it's one design. It's a Breaking Bad theme. Walter White with no shirt on.
Uh-huh. Sure, who wouldn't want that in their backyard all the time? It's a shirt of you?
No, it's for his festival.
Uh-huh.
It's for a festival. With no shirt on.
Yeah.
He's on the Super Soaker. And it says Electric Forest on it.
Okay, cool. Sounds great. Well, that's fine. You can show yourself out. What would you think, Mike, on that dumb website of yours, if we recorded... Hurricane, but AP Mike, right? This is the story of AP Mike, right?
AP Mike was falsely tried.
Living in Bayonne. Like you just...
Living in Bayonne, but one time I could have been the champion of the world.
I'm going to say this, Mike. And I know I'm going to get nothing but grief from Dudio because he's still waiting for these Slaw Dog shirts. Which, trust me, Mike, these Slaw Dog shirts ain't happening. He better not hold his breath.
Breath.
On these Slaw Dog shirts. Look, I'll make the Slaw Dog shirts. Make like six of them. Right? Make one in each size.
What's a Slaw Dog? Just a hot dog with coleslaw?
It was his nickname when he was in high school. They called... Jason Dudio Slaw Dog.
Oh, Slaw Dogs.
So we'll do a Slaw Dog shirt. But we'll do Mike.
Is it based on Straw Dogs?
We did 4 hours of the show about what it was. It turned out it was based on, you can ask Dudio, he'll tell you. What was it even based on? It was based on Goonies, something from Goonies. Steve?
It's our time down here. Down here, it's our time. Steven.
Yes.
There we go, boy. Now you show them how it's really done.
Now, what's the best way to do this, Pat, mic-wise? Is it Should Steve sit where Kurt's sitting? Is that the best bet?
No, I can use these two.
Right there? Okay. Great.
Hey, Tom, how about a little Dukes of Hazzard?
Looks like them Vile boys are in trouble again.
Looks like Paul Vile is in a jam he ain't going to get out of this time. Let's see what goes on this time with these Vile boys.
Yeah.
Steve, do you like Waylon Jennings?
I think so.
Oh, okay. Not like that, though. Not all deep.
Not deep, no.
Look at the big legs on my Levi's. Whoop, 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 whoop.
I'm going to sing a Jersey-appropriate song.
All right. This is the story of AP Mike, the man Tom Sharpling came to like when he said Strozek was fun. People are writing lyrics.
Put in a prison cell, but one time it could have been the champion of the world.
But Mike, are you going to sing it? You want me to sing it? Ugh. Yeah, I know. I want you to sing it. I'll sing it, Mike, then you know what we'll do? How about this? How about this, Mike? A split single with each of us doing a tribute to the other on it. What do you think about that?
That's
right? I'll do the Dylan AP Mike song.
AP Mike cracked a third Coors Light.
But Mike, that means you have to sing a tribute to me. On it, on the other side.
Slept in a Wawa parking lot overnight.
That's
that one. Yeah. One, two.
That's.
One, two.
That's
some stuff. That's the stuff.
This, hello?
Okay. Yes, Steve Gunn in studio.
This song, I figured this was appropriate that we're hanging out in New Jersey. Yeah. Sounds called Wildwood.
I'm going to Ocean City in a couple days.
So yeah, he's going to Ocean City.
So you guys both just write songs about different shore towns. That's like a
thing. Yeah, because Tom, my song is about Ocean City, New Jersey.
I wanted to add another. I was thinking about being on a beach, and I wanted to add maybe a lyric like body like a butterscotch crimpet. Like throw in like a tasty cake.
Well, it could be like that John Mayer song. Like, your body is a butterscotch crimpet. Your body is a butterscotch crimpet.
Your body is butterscotch.
Does that get you mad when he plays with the Grateful Dead?
It made the guy from the Black Crows mad. Christopher Robinson. Christopher Robin.
Great.
Christopher Robin from the Black Crows was mad. He told Howard Stern. Yeah. He's like, this guy's like imitating this and that. I'm like, well, this guy's imitating the small faces and everything.
Yeah.
Say a little thing, I'm a logical.
Yeah. This guy in the Black Crows is borrowing moves from that clown in the Fabulous Thunderbirds.
No, bother, doesn't.
Remember that guy, Mike? Ain't that tough enough?
Ooh, that's a tough one.
That guy. Man around the world. Was that other song they did, Mike? You used to play it all the time. Remember? Oh, it was Wrap It Up. I'll take it. Mike would always play it like, these guys are good. Check these guys out.
Say a little thing to that papa's in it, cause daddy's little hopping on. Gets around.
All right, I'm gonna hand the floor
back
over
to John Mayer.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, I think it upset a lot of people, but then I think he did kind of a good job.
I was there. It wasn't bad.
Yeah, I think he's
his tone
kind of
was a
good...
little metallic, and his I didn't like his hat, his little cap.
Mm-hmm.
But other than that, I didn't care either way.
Did he play...
Bodies of Wonderland?
Did he play Your Bodies of Wonderland, a 45-minute version of it?
Was that... Who was... Because I'm not the biggest Deadhead.
What?
Yeah. Your body is a wonderland.
Who was leading the Who was
drums.
Like the leader of the
band?
Dark Star.
The Dead these days. It's Phil Lesh?
Yeah, it's basically, I think it's Lesh.
I'm playing the Monterey Pop Fest.
Uh-huh.
Same night as...
Is it like Phil Lesh and like Rat Dog or one of those incarnations?
Rat Dog Slim or something.
What about when they all do that thing at the where they play like...
But Bob is a big guy in it, too.
A bigot?
Bigot.
Jane!
Okay. Mike?
He
Mike's a huge Grateful Dead fan.
Mike?
Out there. He loves...
Where's is Andy he a Bob Kindler? Fan? Is he a Bob guy?
He like, he's a pig pen guy.
A pig pen.
You Mike know you gotta give it up. Andy Kindler.
Andy Kindler.
You know you gotta
I want to take it. You want to do it? You want to have it? You got to get it? You know you got to give
You know you got to give it up. You got to give it up.
I'm turning my
I can play guitar to that if you want.
No, just go. Play your song.
Okay, guys. It's the floor is all yours, Steve.
Oh, damn it. Okay, this song's called Wildwood. It's a John Mayer cover.
Come on, bro, just give me that sweet stuff. F the mayor.
Wind so bad, the birds won't move. They're hanging in the air. Pull him out from the sinking sand. Take him to the unknown land. It's how he wants to ride. It's how he wants to ride. You know it runs the private river out into the night. Its flow will help you listen. Keep you out of sight. Its flow will help you listen, keep you out of sight. Your body is a wonderland.
Thanks.
That was awesome.
That's a great song.
You're so good. You're both so good.
Well, that guy's my hero right over
You're
there.
My hero.
You ruined it with John Mayer.
Sorry. I felt inspired. So
I'm just saying.
No, you went
there. That's the whole thing. Just think of that. Like, fathers be good to your daughters. Like, is he a dad? I don't think so. Maybe
no,
he is,
I think
though.
He's a single swinger.
Oh, God.
It seems. But who knows? I don't know. If he's listening, I'm sorry.
My point is, like, that song.
Sorry, dude. If he's listening,
no,
I'm so
don't
sorry.
Be sorry.
Okay. No. But
that song, like, slays John Mayer.
That was awesome.
But that's...
Hey, Mike. Do you like that? Right?
You like it as much as Putney Swope?
I like it as much as the whores on whatever avenue I attend.
What do you like better, Mike? That song or Franklin's Tower?
Hippie Mike was falsely trying.
Can we?
Like that. What do you like better? Help is on the way.
Is there? Can we whip up a version of that?
Two or three walrus and a beach humpback whale.
We what can are, do a version
what
of
are,
me.
What are the chords there for?
What is?
Dylan song.
She said, "Where you been?" I said, "No place special." She said, "You look different." I said, "Well, I guess." She said, "You've been gone." I said, "That's only natural." She said, "You're gonna stay?" I said, "If you want me to, I am."
Oh no.
They're all cartoons at this point, even if they're like the most influential people.
Let's see.
They're all cartoons now.
Bob Dylan?
Yeah, Bob Dylan's a cartoon.
My friend Kian in there, who's sitting in there from Dublin, he just worked a job, like a video shoot.
Okay.
With Bob Dylan.
Really?
And he said that he looks like Bob Dylan and an old lady combined.
Wow.
Combined.
It's really him, but then like there's also like an old lady there as well.
Yeah.
And an old lady combined.
Old lady with a hoodie.
And he told me the story that he was, you kind of like, you know, he's sort of untouchable, you know, that whole thing. And he could hear, you know, because he's got this hot shit band, and they were all rehearsing. But then he heard like this fucking like ripping, like kind of dissonant lead, like sour notes and clams everywhere.
Yeah.
And it's obviously Bob
that he can't play anymore. I heard he can't play guitar anymore.
Yeah, he doesn't. But he was trying. But
well, good.
Anyway,
everybody's got to try. No, we're not busting on him. He did a couple good records, right?
Bob.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, he did a couple. I like the Sinatra one.
I like self-titled. Yeah, like self-titled. I like my
favorite.
I like Knocked Out Loaded. I like Empire Burlesque. I like Triplicate and the Titanic record. And then I've heard good stuff about
the Christmas one.
I heard good stuff about the Christmas stuff, and I've been meaning to get around to the stuff from the 60s.
I love
the lyrics on Santa.
I love Old Mercy. We live in a political world. Love don't have any place. Living in times when men commit crimes of crime. Don't
I like Silvio.
Face. Yeah, that's funny you should mention Silvio. A friend of mine just covered that as if I should know what it is.
Hey, Mike, why don't you come in here? Yeah, how hard would it be to do?
You know,
but there's so many words in this
something.
Thing. It's
you know,
like the longest song
part,
ever.
The saddest part about people like Bob Dylan, who's awesome.
Yeah.
And Neil Young, who's awesome, is like, they're just too famous. They should know that like we could be hanging with them and they'd have a good time.
Yeah,
but they got too many bodyguards.
The
around
hoodie,
them.
The hoodie can come down. We're not going to harm anybody.
Exactly. Take the hoodie down.
Yeah, I mean they should just realize they can hang out. You picture Bob Dylan comes by.
You guys are okay.
He rolls in. He sees AP Mike.
Just drop it, dude.
Mike's like, "Hey Bob, you want a Coors Light?" Right?
Like, you know what? I would like a Coors Light, Mike. Hey, thanks,
okay.
Mike.
Here, let's do that. Let's do all Bob right. Dylan and.
All right.
Okay, here it is. Right. We'll do a radio thing here. Hey, Bob. No, you're not.
Oh, I thought I was.
No, you just listen.
Yeah, just listen.
I'm you. Okay. Why would I want you to be you on this?
I'm sitting here.
Hey, Bob. Yeah, just because you're sitting here, Mike.
Okay.
Okay.
Why would I want you to be? You know who I want you to be?
Yeah.
I want you to be Dudio.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Get those round tones going.
Dudio, you ready for this?
Hey, it's Bob Dylan. Hey, Bob, how are you?
Hey, AP Mike, how's it going?
Hey, you know, every Tuesday night I'm an associate producer on a show on I was on WFMU, now it's a standalone thing on Tuesday. You should come by sometime.
You got one of them Colorado Kool-Aids?
Hey, let me ask if Jason, who's the producer, if he has one. Dudio, do we have any Coors Light?
Of course we do.
It's great to meet you guys.
Who are you going to do, Steve? Who do you do?
I could do... I mean...
We actually dropped the ball. Once we got... We were going to nail it, but...
Do Jello, man. Do Jello.
Okay.
Okay.
I'll try.
We dropped.
Mike, take that mic and talk. Just slide that mic up.
Hey.
So,
whatever.
Yeah.
Whatever. I'm just here.
Yeah. We got... yeah, we got beer. Right, Dudio?
Of course we do.
Oh, this is terrible.
Oh, cool.
Hey, is that Jello Man?
Yeah, it's me. Shut up, Kurt.
Sure.
No, I didn't. Mom said that. I don't know.
Now, do Bob Dylan.
What?
Giving directions.
To Jello Man?
All right, what?
To Jello Man at a festival. Like where he can set.
I wish I set my Jello tent up.
Hey,
Bob.
Oh, so you're doing Jello?
I was for a second. Sorry. No, I'll do.
Hey, I'm here at the festival with my friend Jello Man. Bob, where should we set our tent up?
Hey, Bob. Do you know my brother?
Where should we?
Bob, where should we? Kurt Bob's brother. Do it. You want to buy a t-shirt?
Where can we set the Jello stand up?
Just turn right.
There. That's it. I got so sidetracked. You know, like, we were going to nail it. We were going to nail it, but then we didn't.
Mm-hmm. Now, who else can you do impressions of, Kurt?
I can do anybody.
You do Jennifer from Royal Trucks.
Oh, yeah. That's my girl.
Yeah.
That's love.
You do Neil Young, Bob Dylan.
I could do anybody.
All right, we'll do somebody. That I don't do one I haven't heard yet.
Tell me if you know who this is.
Okay.
Ready?
I'm going to beat you with the crowbar until you leave.
You know who that is?
No.
Who the hell are you? Peace, love, dope.
Wait, who is that?
All right, well.
Mike?
I don't know who that is.
Forget it then.
Mike, answer it at studio, though.
Can I take a guess?
No, this stinks.
Who is it?
It's James Earl Jones in Field of Dreams.
Okay. Well, no one.
Wow, okay.
Look, they all can't be your Neil Young. They all can't be Robin Leach, baby.
Yeah, you're right.
All right, Mike, get out.
Yeah, because Mike is the one who sidetracked this bit.
You really did.
I'm sorry. Sorry. I'm just kidding, Mike. Mike is the peon so much.
So, Steve, what's coming up for 2000? When do you work on this next album?
I'm working on it actually right now down in Philly.
Okay.
And, yeah, I'm going to doing some more touring. I'm going down south, and then I'm going to Australia and New Zealand.
Okay.
Which I'm really psyched about.
The album is the album an end of the year kind of thing, or is this a next year?
It'll be next year.
Next year. Yeah. Same for you, Kurt?
What?
Next year? Album?
Yeah, I have something that they're going to announce soon. That'll come out sometime, I guess, this year. Right?
Okay. Get up on that mic.
I got something, a little something coming out this year. I want to say this year a little something's coming out for sure.
Like a special thing that nobody's expecting.
Well, some might expect, but Mm-hmm. I was told I can't announce it.
All right.
And it's going to be announced in a few days.
Okay.
And then, I'm working on my new album. I would say the album's going to, what is this, 2017?
It is.
My full length will be out next year for sure.
Okay.
And I'm working on a soundtrack.
The soundtrack to the porno movie.
That's right. And Tom.
What's that?
Are you done with show business and entertainment aside from your...
My friend, I am not. I finished writing a script.
Ah, that's
beautiful.
A couple
days ago. I'm back.
Because I like this side of... I want to... One day we're all going to be in a really beautifully stupid movie together, right? Mm-hmm. Will you be in my movie? I'll put Jello Man in it even.
Sure. You know, somebody linked something that's on Pitchfork already about your thing, so...
Yeah, I know, but I was told I can't.
Okay, that's fine. Look, I'm just saying.
It's out there.
We're not saying it. The intrepid.
Yeah.
An intrepid sort can go figure
I'm
things out
saying,
for themselves.
I'm not saying.
But this is not some top secret thing, is what you're saying.
It's not top secret. They're just like literally going to just make some announcement in a few days of more than what you're reading. And I don't care either way.
Exactly.
I don't care either way. I was told not to say.
Let the guy.
This is so.
Right?
Look, son of a...
Look, let the guy just be himself. Right? Look, Kurt's going to give us something that's going to be...
Let the boy...
Right? What are you going to say that's Pitchfork worthy?
I've already said a lot.
Like, you can come up with something. Like, who sucks?
Who sucks?
Yeah.
Why don't you throw some at me? I'll tell you if they suck. Anybody.
John Mayer.
Does John Mayer suck? Like, in one way, of course he does. In another way,
he wasn't that bad.
What am I going to be, Chris Robinson?
And he did a good job.
And look,
he did a good job on with the dead stuff, I think. I didn't see
look,
it.
Like Steve's Steve's cutting up some slack.
Sorry.
Of course he stinks.
It's all right.
But it's also...
Joe Walsh.
The coolest eagle, for sure.
Yeah, but what's that saying?
Wait,
well,
but what
that's
was
like
his
the,
solo
that's like being
again?
The best
what's
Washington
the
general.
No, what's that trio? The power trio.
Yeah, James Gang.
James Gang, of course.
Yeah,
look,
he
was,
great. Yeah, I like that song.
Let's have to break some of the cursing. We got to watch the cursing. That's all right.
All right, give me somebody else. I'll tell you if they suck.
I'm going to go over to Pitchfork. Figure someone out.
Let's see.
Even if they're my best, even if they're my best friends, they probably stink. Just lay it on me.
Radiohead.
Stunk.
All right.
Who else? I want to hate them, but I think their music is really good.
Byrne.
It doesn't matter. Their music might be good, but they still stink.
Interpol.
Stink. Who else?
Grizzly Bear.
Stink. Who else?
Sunny Day Real Estate.
Stink. Who else?
John Coltrane.
Stink. He's not on Pitchfork. Come on.
Eddie
Don't throw John Coltrane
Pearl
in here.
Pearl Jam.
Stink. Who else?
Led Zeppelin.
Stink. Who else?
Police.
Come on, we're just doing Pitchfork here.
Oh,
tell
sorry,
me some
sorry.
More. Modern.
Oh, Pitchfork.
Modern day things. Tell me.
All right.
What's the fuck?
Sorry.
Can
I bounce this? What is this? This is not a Matador. Bleachers.
Stinks. Who else?
Fun.
Stinks. Who else?
A Flying Lotus.
Stunk.
All right. TV on the radio.
Stinks.
So, this is a little... It's getting a little thinner when you just say everybody stinks.
No, I know. Okay, give me somebody one
the
more.
The Clean.
Well, The Clean's good.
Mary Lattimore.
Stinks.
No, she doesn't.
No.
She's
my friend.
Of course she is. She's my friend, too. I'm sure she's your friend, too, Steve.
She is, yeah.
She get her here with her harp, right?
That would be cool.
No,
make her lug that harp down the street.
She's like living in L.A. She's experimenting with flower power.
So we make her bring the harp on a plane, then.
She's at the Headlands residence.
Look, I can't blame her. I might go to L.A. Maybe I'm ready for L.A., right?
What, to move?
Yeah, Lipstick City.
That's fine. I'll go with you.
Right? Yeah.
Listen, I like a little show.
You're ready for your L.A. period.
Hey, Tom.
You're ready for your Robbie Robertson,
hey, Tom,
Martin Scorsese.
Shangri-La. Tom, yeah. That's entertainment.
What is?
That.
How about the band? We can admit that the band, not so hot, right?
Yeah, not so hot.
Right?
Hmm.
Right?
Obviously they're good, but also, like, a lot of it,
they have
overrated.
They have a lot of
overrated
music that no one's...
Overrated.
Yeah.
I like them. Yeah.
I like them, too, but they're still overrated.
They're not humor. They're not
like
funny to me. And there's,
snob,
there's nothing
right.
fun about
they're
it.
Snobs.
They were the first people to
my
make music
story,
not fun.
My favorite story, the band, is like Robbie Robertson, whatever his name is.
Mm-hmm.
He, during when they got back together with Dylan for, what is that? What's the album they got to Planet West.
Yes.
Planet
yes.
West.
Oh,
yeah.
And Robbie Robertson was like, to the producer, whoever he was, he's like, listen, I'm going to say how I think it should be. And you're going to say it like it's your idea to Bob. And then he won't listen to me, but he'll listen to you. So you're going to say whatever I tell you, you're going to say that's what you think. That's a true story. And these guys are like, okay. I don't know if he did or not, you know. But I was like, nah, damn.
What about a supergroup? What about a Philly supergroup that's traveling Philberries? I pitched it.
Mm.
Kurt, huh? Steve, throw what's his face in there?
Hooters.
Get one of the get Eric or Rob in there from the Hooters, right?
Yeah,
fine.
What's his face from War on Drugs?
He's in L.A.
Are Gamble and Huff? Are they?
We'll get Huff, Rodney Anonymous. It'll be Huff. It'll be Kurt, Steve. What's his name again? Keith?
Schooly D, too.
No, in War on Drugs, Keith.
Keith? Are you talking about my old buddy Adam?
Doesn't he go by Keith now, though?
Keith, give me a break.
Get Keith from War on Drugs. Steve, Kurt, Keith, Rodney Anonymous, Huff, and...
Daryl Hall.
I see you're leaving Joe, embarrassingly in the dust.
Joe?
You give it Rodney Anonymous, but no Joe?
Well, it's a super group. We can't take everyone from the group. Then it's.
I think Joe's more active than Rodney.
Then we'll get Joe in. Rodney, sorry, Rodney, you're out. And Huff and one of the Hooters. And it's called the Traveling Philberries.
Fine.
Just say a Hooter.
A Hooter. A Hooter. A Hooter to be named later. Just like in a sports trade.
I think I played street hockey with one of the Hooter. A Hooter. I don't
know. With a Hooter?
Well, 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 well.
All right. Paul? Questlove. Somebody wants Questlove in the group. I'm not putting him in.
Yeah,
the
I'll put Questlove in.
Well, he would just.
He's shy, though. He's real shy.
He would just be there, but he would just. Because he just would, like, the force of. Would just conjure
you only,
him.
You're only as good as your drummer, and we need Questlove.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Sure. Well, what if with the Hooter is the drummer, then?
Nah.
No?
Stinks.
We could have two drummers like the Dead.
Yeah. Could have two drummers like the Dead, or Allman Brothers, or the Dirt Bombs. Would you ever play with two drummers? Two drummers, the force of two drummers?
Yes.
Would you like that?
I think it's a bit of a gimmick, but...
What about three drummers?
There you go. Now you're talking.
Well, I saw
Have
King Crimson.
It?
I saw. Wow. It was okay. The greatest thing
wow.
imaginable. They had three drummers.
Was this in Jersey?
No, this was in New York a few years ago. They're playing Jersey in July.
Was Fripp hanging?
Yeah.
Wow.
It was great.
Wow.
It was the greatest.
They did 21st Century Schizoid Man?
They did that. They
oh
did
God.
Starless. They did Fracture. What's up? Get in here. The pizza
so
party
pizza.
Out there? Are you going to do a song?
Come on. Can you
no?
just ad-lib
just
a song?
Just do any
I'll
song.
Play guitar.
Just do any song with Steve sing.
It's,
Steve
you
playing.
You
sing it.
A Jello what, Shot promotion.
What's yeah. What's a song you would sing? We're doing like an old-fashioned hootenanny in here.
I'll just play a couple of chords and you can... No pressure, though.
Can't think of any off the top of my head.
What's like a thing to the tune of something? Right? Do it to the...
Get on the
Jello shots, Jello shots. All I got is Jello shots. They taste so good. Pink, berry blue, cottage cheese. Look at you. Jello shots. They feel like they make me feel like this. Not. Touch me with your Jello shot. Please touch me with your Jello shot.
Give your info out.
You can find me on JelloMan.com or Instagram. JelloMan Philly on Instagram.
Tell a story.
Huh?
Tell a story.
I was walking down the street, Jello shot in my hand. I was walking by the street where I made my first Jello shot. I sold it to a bum. He put it on his tongue. He swallowed it whole and he ate it there. And I watched him give me $2 then. From there I took it to Bonnaroo. All the other festivals do. And I made a buck, put it in my pocket, and then I ran away and did it all again.
Sing about AP Mike. Sing about how you and AP Mike went camping.
Excuse me?
Sing about you and AP Mike when you went camping.
There was let's get it right here. Ching, 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 ching. AP Mike. Me and him went up to the mountains together.
Oh, so
we took out our knives and we went fishing with them. We jumped in a pool of water there. We caught an eel. Then we caught a sunfish. That's it.
Okay, that's enough.
That's all it's going.
What do you think about that, Mike?
I was just thinking about the viewers.
Yeah. Suddenly I'd be grateful to be dead.
I forgot they were there.
It's not viewers. No. No, they'd be called listeners if there were any of them left also. But they're... No, they're gone now. That was great. No, they're all gone. That was like a Jefferson Airplane song.
Yeah. Tell them all hookah, smoking character.
All right.
You watched them.
All right, get out. I'm not going to have an off thing come. You asked me about if I... All right. All right, Kurt, you can go back in the chair, please, in the big boy chair.
Big boy.
Yeah, show me it later, like after the show's over. Hey, Mike.
Yeah.
What are we doing here?
That was bar none the most beautiful song I've ever heard in my life.
Do you think there's a chance? What is the chance that ends up on the next Kurt Vile record?
150%.
What if you looked into a crystal ball, Kurt, and you saw you're performing that song on The Tonight Show?
What, with Jimmy Fallon?
Yeah. And you're up there and you're just like,
have you met
Jello shots, Jello shots.
Oh, yeah. Because it was like some kind of like Disneyland fairy tale.
Or
it
catches on.
Not.
Yeah, like it catches on somehow.
Well, on Jim. Do you ever meet Jimmy Fallon? You know Jimmy Fallon?
Yeah, I met Jimmy Fallon.
Is he a nice guy?
He's all right. Not according to Andy Kindler.
Well, he's afraid. He was a. He put his fingers through Trump's hair that
I met him a long time ago.
That ruffled a couple feathers.
Look, I'll say this. you could want to vote for Donald Trump, he'd be your favorite thing. I still wouldn't want to touch that dude's hair.
Yeah.
He could be your favorite politician in the history of humanity, and you're still going to, like, touch that hair?
That's lame.
Like, that's the weird, like, who would want to touch, like, why would you want to touch that? It's like, right, Mike? All right, who's good here, Mike? These people have been holding an hour and a half. Best show.
Hey there, this is Mike calling from Somerville, Massachusetts.
What's up, Mike?
I had a story about a time I recorded Kurt Vile, but I also wanted to say I grew up in Pennsylvania, and Philly was my city for going to shows, and I used to shop at Third Street Rock and Jazz, and Brother JT is from Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, where I grew up, so it's good to hear all this old PA talk. So I'm the engineer for MIT student radio station, so I'm like the dudio of that place, but without the on-air charisma. And Kurt Vile, about 10 years ago, I guess, when Constant Hitmaker either had just come out or was about to come out, the music director, I guess, got in touch with him and invited him down. And at that time, it was him and Adam G., now in Warren Drugs, and I guess it was probably a four-piece. And
who?
I think the night... Adam G.
But who's
Adam,
the other person you named?
So Kurt Vile, Adam. Oh, you Ken, said, did you call him Ken?
No, you said Kurt Vile, Adam,
yep.
And then Adam, Warren.
No, Adam G. Who is in War on Drugs?
Oh,
now.
I thought you said his name was Warren Drugs.
No, sorry.
No.
No. So they were a four-piece, and I think they had played with Cheater Slicks the night before. So anyway, they came into the studio to do an in-studio, much like they're doing with you guys tonight. And as we set up, there's like a half an hour of work putting up microphones while they're playing around with pedals and such. And so I was eager to talk Philly with Kurt because it's a city I know and love. And so I said something like, so how do you spend your time in Philly? And he said, oh, well, I work at Yards Brewery, so I'm there every day. And I said, oh, what do you do at Yards Brewery? And he proceeded to say, I'm paraphrasing, but he's like, it's like really simple stuff, just like super simple stuff, like, sometimes they'll, you know, I'll fold boxes for the upcoming release, and sometimes I'll, like, you know, drive the forklift around, but it's all like, it's like super simple stuff. And, I thought it was both charming, but also pretty funny, because, you know, we've come
okay,
to know.
Oh, hey, what? Okay. All right. You're taking the scenic route on this story. You got to admit
that. All right. Wrapping it up, but we've come to know him to be like, you know, a big success. But on that particular day, like 10 years ago, he was bragging about how simple the stuff they asked him to do at Yard Brewery.
I wouldn't say I was bragging, but I know what you mean, though.
All right, that was a trip down memory lane. I appreciate the call.
All right.
Oh, that's mean.
Best show. Hi.
Hello, this is Ethan in Brooklyn.
What's up, Ethan?
I was just calling to ask what you think of the Emoji Movie.
Oh, it looks great.
What do you think of...
you look so pissed.
What do you think of T.J. Miller in the lead role?
I think he's going to be the ultimate emoji, and I'm already... spending a lot of my time figuring out what theater I'm going to sit outside of to try to get in first.
And Patrick Stewart?
I can't wait that he's an emoji also. It sounds... Look, it's not for me. What do you think I'm going to say? I can't wait to see it? It's not for me. I'm not 11. Emoji movie. Look, would I do a voice in the Emoji Movie? Of course I would. I'd push someone into traffic to do a voice in the Emoji Movie. They're not asking. So if they're not asking, they ain't doing me no good. Of course they should. But they're not. Look, my friend, Ethan, first of all, you're a troublemaker.
Sorry.
What do you think of TJ Miller?
You're trying to get me to trash talk this guy. Right?
He's a funny guy.
He's funny.
He is. I agree.
He's funny on Silicon Valley. He's a funny guy. So,
he is. I agree.
I remember me Carpoolers. He was Heathcliff on Carpoolers. So, what do you think? I'm going to badmouth the guy? No. But you're a little troublemaker, Ethan. But look at this. I realize this. Ain't no emoji movie going to come knocking on my door. Ain't no none of this is going to come knock. I got to build my own thing.
Yeah.
That's fine. I'm fine with that. I built this own studio here, me and me alone. I built it. Wait, no, Dudio. That's why he's called Dudio. He's a dude who built the studio. I watched Dudio build this studio.
On rock and roll.
On rock and roll. He built this studio on rock and roll. No, you're a mischief maker. Not into it. Get off my phone.
Tom.
Yeah, what's that, Kurt Vile?
I just want to know if you like this one TV show. It's terrible. It hurts so bad. It's so bad. I'm really slow with TV, but tell me, did you ever watch this show at all? Nashville? Did you ever watch it at all?
No, I didn't.
Never? Not even one episode?
No. I only saw the movie.
Oh.
Did you see the movie?
Yeah. Well, I didn't even get through that.
Hold on.
The TV show's worse.
Did you watch the movie?
Yeah, it's one of the greatest movies ever made. You like it? Okay.
It's a masterpiece.
I'm going to watch it again.
It's one of the three best movies I've ever seen.
Really?
Yeah.
That's a lie.
It is not.
Really?
Yeah. Steve, have you ever seen the movie Nashville?
I'm a huge Altman fan.
I love Altman. I do. But
it's
like
really.
That,
it's okay, the culmination. If you watch it with being ready to watch it, it's a commotion.
It's a commotion.
But that's what the whole thing is.
Well, that's what he does.
It is a commotion.
All right. If you're serious, I'll rewatch it.
I swear I'm totally serious.
I just never got past the first half hour because the whole
thing. Either you're in or you're not.
But you never watch one episode?
No, I didn't.
All right, fine. It's over.
But it's made. It's over. The movie's made to be like an immersive experience.
And you said three movies? Did you have two?
I think it's one of my three favorite movies.
What are the other two?
Probably the Emoji Movie, and then I guess the other one I'm going to say is probably Under Siege.
Mm.
It's a Steven Seagal
one. Two or one?
Two.
Okay.
I like The Abyss.
You like The Abyss? Best show.
Bomb.
Yeah. What?
You like my accent, no?
No, you got a gruff voice. I don't know where your accent is unless your voice is over-modulating. That's your accent?
It could be over-modulating. I suspect that it at times could be over-modulating. What about yours? I mean, you say that you speak to the street and yours doesn't over-modulate?
Does my voice over-modulate?
I think it does.
Okay, well, sometimes it does. Sometimes it doesn't.
I'm calling to wish you a very happy evening, not to already get into disgruntlement.
Look, I'm here with my friends Steve Gunn and Kurt Vile. They came down, they played nice music for everybody. Did you like those songs?
So you're there with Kurt Vile?
Oh my god, I hate this guy's voice.
Kurt? What? This is some random dude, genuinely speaking, out in Maryland, who has been so influenced by your music and has taken it to heart. This is we speak sarcastically on this show all the time. I know everybody
Wait,
does.
We
this is
who? Which is we genuine, business? We do? Do. You ain't we, my friend. You ain't my friend. We.
Okay, all right, so I'm not going to use that pronoun. I'm sorry.
We. It's like you say we the way people, when they talk about a baseball team, that they're not in.
What's a pronoun?
A pronoun? You don't know what a pronoun is?
No.
Well, we need to settle that first and foremost.
Well, first of all, I know who you are. You're a troublemaker also.
I am. I very much am.
Well, why don't you say something nice for once in your
I've
sad
tried
life.
To say something nice. I'm trying to wish you a very lovely evening.
Yeah. Why don't you say
it's
something
true.
Nice? Say
true.
Something
it's
nice.
True.
Say something nice.
I'm not lying.
It's morning
this
now.
Is
actually.
Not a
yeah.
lie.
Thanks.
I'm really calling to reach out in goodwill. To
how
say
dare you?
You're having a good evening. Why do you reject that? Why is that?
Why do you reject that?
Oh come on!
Because your voice is just dripping with. Yeah, you're like the audio version of a. So what are you trying to do here? Is this really what you're? Well, what are you trying to do here with your call?
No, this
bro?
Is actually. I'm Ian. I'm sorry.
Sounds a little. Oh,
bit it's Ian. Well, who does he sound a little bit like?
Oh, I don't know.
No, I don't know this guy.
He sounds a little bit like drunk. I don't know.
He sounds.
No,
drunk.
I'm not.
No, he's
I'm
clearly
not.
Drunk.
I am too.
No, I'm not. That is
it's,
not.
It's
true.
All right. You're drunk. It's okay.
It's all right. It's all right. You're drunk. So am I.
Just go lay down. Your head will spin for a while. No, hopefully you don't throw up in the middle of the night.
Whoa. So Frank Zappa was drunk?
What? What is that?
Yeah.
Well,
you're as bad as Frank Zappa.
The wackos are automatically
He's not a Frank Zappa was the opposite of a wacko.
You're not Frank
He was a
Zappa.
Controlling bully.
I'm not
a wacko. What? How is he a wacko?
Because
he sang toilet lyrics, that makes him a wacko.
That's not the point I'm trying to make.
Dave going down, got to
cause
toilet blues.
Watch out where the Huskies go, and don't you eat that yellow snow.
Watch out, you got to clog toilet, baby.
Don't even get me started on that.
On what?
We won't.
Hey, you know of Vita Blue?
What?
Vita Blue.
What, the baseball player?
Yeah.
Oh, you're so boring. You are so boring.
I actually like the way he said yeah that time.
No, well, it's one moment. Okay, out of 11 minutes, he came up with a good 3 seconds.
Ah!
That seems to be about his batting average. And he did it again and took it away.
Yeah.
Ah!
Oh, you're so boring. What's it like to be that
on,
boring?
Me. I've got so
I
many
don't
great
love you.
To tell you about.
You're boring. You're a bore.
Have you talked about Chris Cornell tonight?
That's mean.
Yeah, what am I supposed to talk? What do you want me to
no,
talk
we
about?
No, talk about Chris Cornell.
What, you can't talk about Chris Cornell?
No.
Why would I talk about it?
Why wouldn't you?
That's not nice. You're not nice.
Yeah, look, the poor guy, it was clearly had problems, and I'm not going to talk about that. Well, you think that's funny? I don't think it's funny.
Why would you assume that I...
Because you got this smirky quality in your voice. Why didn't you talk about it? You didn't talk about it. Why not?
Hey, Tom, that's your problem. That's not mine.
Well, it's your problem, bro, because it's my show.
Oh, because you're a street fluffing blow maker, snow hazing mother.
Wow.
I don't even know what that meant. It's like the
oh, it meant so much to you, you don't even know.
Yeah, I guess I don't. I guess, oh, please let me be on your level. Oh, let me be on your level, guy who was on hold for 80 minutes.
You want to try to be on my level again. Wow, this is where that's going.
I'm actually scared of him.
He should be. He's a creep. This guy's a creep. Look, I've talked to this guy off the air. He's admitted that he's a comedian. He's an improviser. He's trying to do stuff, and he wants me to come check him out. I won't. So he calls up with these angry calls because he's a frustrated performer who can't get his career going, and he's taking it out on me in the audience because I won't give him the time of day and watch some dumb video he sent me.
Kurt, are you there?
No, I'm not here.
Kurt.
No,
Kurt,
what?
Kurt, he's killing me. This is not true.
Okay.
Did you or did you not email me?
Vita Blue with his stats back in 1982 would tell you, he would tell you otherwise.
What are you talking about, man?
You're so
man,
boring.
Man, you guys must be grasping for straws.
You're so boring. I'm actually marveling at how somebody could be as consistently boring as you.
I love being as boring as I possibly
I'm glad you love it, because you certainly are it.
Well, that's what I try to do. Have you seen any hummingbirds?
No.
They're so uninteresting.
I've never liked animals.
Come on!
This is what this guy does all the time. Hey, you gonna go buy a new couch? Come on! What do you want to talk about buying a new couch? Come on! What's wrong with you?
Hey, if you got some upholstery, I can give it to you.
Oh my God.
What a snooze. You're a snooze, bro. And I'm not going to watch your dumb videos. No matter how many times you send me the videos, I'm not watching them. I'm not going to come check your dumb improv troupe out. There's a reason why you didn't get into the Del Close thing. I'm not going to help you get into it. I don't care.
Do you think I care about getting into any of these clubs?
That's what you wrote me. That's why you keep emailing me.
I've never emailed you once in my life.
Yeah, I wish you only emailed me once in my life.
What about Giggles? Go down to Giggles. Giggles down in Wildwood.
Yeah.
Hey, buy the blue.
Oh my God! Please give me some. Relief.
Final call. Best show.
Hi, Tom.
Hi, to whom am I speaking?
This is Evan from Saskatchewan. Hello, all.
What's up, Evan? That guy's the worst caller in the history of the show.
We love you so much, whoever you
are. Come on, what's going on?
I've never experienced that in my life.
That was tough.
Listening or being on
your show. Oh, that guy sucks.
Come on.
Right, Mike? Why'd you let him through then? That's a blemish on Mike's thing.
His thing.
Mike, you shouldn't have let him through. You know what I'm taking?
That's a blemish on your thing, Mike.
Mike, I'm taking away...
blunder.
I'm taking it away from you. Yeah. Mike, give me all your 77 dead shows. I'm going to smash them in the street. That's your punishment. Even when they played Hunter College or whatever that one show you are always talking about. You got to hear this version of Crazy Fingers. Come on!
Oh, my God.
Come on. You don't like the Grateful Dead? You don't like when they do Mississippi Half-Step Uptown Toodaloo? Come on!
You couldn't have me more wrong. Oh, my God.
So what's going on there in Saskatchewan, bro?
I'm in Vancouver right now, but I just wanted to thank the fellas for all the music in studio and out. And I had a hypothetical question for y'all.
Hello.
So if you were to... Sorry, go ahead, Kurt.
No, you go.
I just said you sound like a country bumpkin. Go.
I am a country bumpkin. So if you guys were to... if you're able to pull an old legend out of obscurity and produce his or her album in sort of the style that everybody's done in the past, who would that be?
Yes.
Mike Love.
Mike Love. So Steve, you'd work with Mike Love.
Steve.
No, it's a joke.
You know you call your record? Love Gun.
Whoa.
Gun. Right?
Yeah.
Love Gun. Think about it.
Okay.
Love Gun.
Disgusting.
Right? Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Love Gone. Love Gone. It's Kiss.
Oh, Gene Simmons.
Yes, Gene Simmons. One of the members of Kiss.
That's the only one I know.
So you'd bring Steve Gunn would bring Mike Love. You'd walk him into the Matador offices. Patrick.
But what about Vile Genes?
No, I'm not going to work with that guy.
No, you said Gene. Okay, sorry.
He insulted Terry Gross, and that's my neighbor. He insulted Terry Gross, and that's my neighbor. And she was like, that is a very offensive.
Steve Gunn walks Mike Love into the Matador offices.
That is a very offensive thing to say.
Gerard, I'd like you to meet my best friend, Mike Love. Right? Is that how it goes?
It's Gerard be like, that is crazy.
Who would you bring out of retirement or whatever, Kurt? Who would you work with?
Oh man. Most of my heroes are dead. Fuck. Sorry.
You're gonna be serious?
I'm sorry.
Look, do a serious. You can do a serious
okay,
one.
Alright, I'll take that one.
I'm sorry, Tom.
Do a serious one, it's alright, Kurt.
That's how passionate I am, I'm sorry.
I know.
about that. Literally all my heroes. Because I, you know who I thought of? I don't even want to say it. Can I say if are they dead? If they're dead?
Who?
Waylon Jennings. He's my favorite these days.
All right. So you would work with Waylon Jennings?
Absolutely. And he would work with me, too.
Yeah. He'd like you.
I would...
think.
Someone who's still around. And he has Skrillex? To be obscure.
Skrillex?
Oh, did he say obscure?
Like, I'll pull him out of obscurity?
Like, would you... Yeah, like if Skrillex hit hard times.
Yeah.
Skrillex?
Yeah.
Is Vanilla Ice... What's he up to?
No.
He's in a lot of Adam Sandler movies. Tonight
I'm
on
trying,
the show,
okay, I'll be serious.
We've
maybe,
got Steve Gunn and Skrillex.
Did he say obscure?
Can I pipe in?
Sure.
Sure.
So here's an example. Jerry Lewis did one. He had old Swing and a Miss. He had Kid Rock and all these people.
Like Jerry Lewis, like Martin and Lewis?
Sorry. My apologies. Jerry Lee Lewis.
Oh, he's not obscure. He's
so
the greatest.
He jammed with Kid
I know,
Rock.
But he did one, and it was just a huge miss.
Right, so he jammed with Kid Rock.
Yeah, but he jammed with a lot of people on that record. I just saw him at Stagecoach.
What a treat that is for Jerry Lee Lewis.
What about Little Richard?
There you go.
He's not obscure.
Nor is Jerry Lee Lewis.
He's living in Nashville.
Here's the super jam. Steve Gunn, Skrillex,
Mike Love,
and Little Richard.
Hey, did you mention Jerry Lee Lewis? Did you ever read Hellfire?
Just picture that band.
I haven't read Hellfire.
Read it, and then you won't be telling me he's obscure.
Picture this band.
I understand.
Close your eyes and picture this band. Steve Gunn. Mike Love. Jerry Lee Lewis. No, Little Richard and Skrillex.
Skrillex ruined it. You know, there's a YouTube YouTube-umentary where Skrillex... works with the Doors while Ray Manzarek is still alive. Oh. And they're like, oh, I can't wait to work with the Doors. Here it is. Here's my track. And, like, clearly the Doors, they were like, their manager told them they should do this with Skrillex, modern guy. And then, like, so he's like, here's my track. And then he plays the track, and you see all the Doors, and especially Ray Manzarek. And they have so much fear in their eyes when they realize what they've, like, been, like, you know, what happened, like, what they've been, reduced to or whatever. Like, so he's playing the track. It's like, and, like, Ray Manzarek's like, he's like, and then it's done. And then Ray's like, okay, it's a start.
Have you ever
And then they work on a track together. Does it know about this?
No, I don't.
You got to look it up.
Ouch.
Have you ever seen the Lou Reed Pavarotti video?
Oh, yeah, I play it all the time.
Oh, man, incredible.
What?
Hey, Tom.
It's such a perfect day. I'd like to spend it with you.
Lou Reed and Pavarotti.
Such a perfect day.
So somebody sings that, and Lou, what does Lou do?
It's Lou Reed and Pavarotti, like.
Yeah, Lou Reed and Pavarotti
in
playing.
Italy. On a huge stage.
You know it.
So Pavarotti's like, and he's like,
Lou Reed is
and
going.
And Lou's like, yeah.
Look, I've played it on the show before. You know what I'm going to do right
now?
Play
it again.
I'm playing it again because we're in the bonus. If you don't like it, shut it show off. Right, Mike? Just like you say, Mike, when somebody plays, when somebody doesn't want to hear you play Jack Straw, right? Right, Mike? When you're trying to turn someone on to estimated profit from
77
from set, Mike usually plays to 79. Mike usually goes to 79 with estimated profit.
Got it.
Hey Tom,
yeah.
I just want to say love to the Good Brothers and Sadie's. Thanks for the Sadie's love tonight.
They're the greatest band. They're the greatest living band.
Out of Canada, for sure.
Modern times.
Thanks for the call, bro. Here you go. Played it before. I'm playing it again.
Yeah.
They both walk out.
Is that a YouTube?
It's YouTube, yeah. It's a YouTube.
Just a perfect day. Drink sangria in the park. And then later, when it gets dark, we go home. Just a perfect day. Feed the animals in the zoo. Then later, and then home.
Yeah. He's playing his Steinberger. Sweet Lou, you do a Lou Reed song.
Me?
Yeah.
What did I do?
Sword of Damocles.
Oh, you want me to do it right now?
Yeah, I do.
Really?
Yes.
You got it?
I did it so long ago, but I could do some of it at least.
From Magic and Loss.
I see the sword of Damocles is right above your head, yeah. They try a new treatment to get you out of bed. But radiation kills both bad and good, it cannot differentiate. So to heal you, they must kill you. The sword of Damocles hangs above your head. That mix of morphine and dexedrine, we use it on the street. Kills the pain and keeps you up, your very soul to keep. So to hear you, they must kill you. The sword of Damocles hangs above your head.
Alright, that's all I'm doing. That song's so dark. It's beautiful, though.
It's a great song.
It is.
Great album.
It's dark.
Think about.
I used to play that when I was like literally a teenager.
I know your favorite album, your favorite Lou Reed album, of course, is Mistrial.
No, my favorite is New Sensations because I love the song Never Hit a Woman.
Yeah.
Where the refrain is, I try to remember, never hit a woman. I try to remember.
Yeah. You might want to try real hard.
But like it, to his like defense, it is the '80s when it came out. Look. Because back then they had to try to remember
to not hit women.
I try to remember, never hit a woman. New Sensations. He's got like a joystick. He's just sitting there in his leathers.
He was a big champion of video games for people. He was did that he? One song. The final song on New Sensations is that video game song about Defender, isn't that what it is?
I don't know. You were texting me.
Oh,
might as well have been on Christmas.
You were
texting me. It might as well have been on Christmas Day. You're like, I've been listening to every Lou Reed album.
I listened to all of them. I listened to all of them in a row. And I'm going to do a podcast. We're going to start in a few weeks. It's going to be reviewing every Lou Reed album and every Adam Sandler movie.
Well, I got a favorite Adam Sandler.
What's that?
Click.
You like Click?
Yeah.
You're pro Click. Mike, ask Studio what his favorite Adam Sandler movie is, please. Now, Mike, answer back in duty with your Dudio impression. That's the meanest thing. These guys truly hate each other out there.
No.
Because a Dudio impression is more like this. I'm kind of partial to Little Nicky. And then Mike goes, I'm kind of partial to Little Nicky. Well, first of all, Little Nicky's a great movie. Steve?
Yes.
Favorite Adam Sandler movie?
Is he in Sandlot? No.
No, that's his name.
I'm not a big
Adam Sandlot.
No, but
I don't really know.
Click is funny because it's like obviously when he's out of his prime.
Yeah.
Because Billy Madison is actually funny. Even you might not
Billy
remember it.
Billy Madison and Happy Gilmore are masterpieces.
Yeah. Okay, I'm glad you agree.
Yes. Little Nicky is like those movies, but is also great.
Click has one part that's so funny just because it's so stupid. Because, you know, Click, the premise is he's so lazy eating ding-dongs and ho-hos through his, like, middle years with his family that, like, all of a sudden he finds this remote. When anybody asks him to remember anything, he can rewind. So then one day his wife is like, you know, you remember our first song? He's like, oh, sure I do. And then he rewinds to it. It's their first date when they're in high school and they start dancing. It's like their first dance and it's Do You Have to Let It Linger, the Cranberry song. And then they almost kiss. They're about to kiss and then he's watching himself as he's young and then he starts singing along. And he's got like an Irish accent and he's like, you know I'm such a fool for you.
Yeah, it is.
It's so stupid. It's pretty good.
It's a good song, right?
I kind of do like
the Cranberry. Do You Have to? Do you have to?
Do you have to?
Do you have to let it linger? I'm such a fool for you, right?
You know I'm such a fool for you.
You do other songs like that, right?
Yeah. Do you have to? By the way, that was Paul's favorite band growing up.
Cranberries.
Is that true, Paul?
Yeah. He would imitate the yodel.
No.
Now he'd always be like, Malayai, Malayai. He'd always be imitating that for sure.
Jello, right? Hey, hello, best show.
Hello.
Hi, you're the final call tonight.
Well, I'm honored. Hi, Kurt. Hi, Steve. Hi, Tom.
What's up, brother? Oh yeah. I'm telling you.
Why would you do that? I start doing it, then you do it over me. Is that really how?
Sorry.
Well, what's your name?
Ben.
Ben, where are you calling from, Ben?
Seattle.
What's going on in Seattle tonight?
Not much.
You hanging out with?
My kids are asleep.
Okay, wake them up. Pour some cold water on their heads. Right? Go in their room. This is what you do. Get some ice water. Fill a glass with ice. Then fill it with cold water. Dump it on their heads. Whoa. Right? But yeah. Put on, do you have any kind of mask or anything you could wear? A scream mask?
I could fashion one.
Why don't you wrap a bed sheet around your face to look like that Mars Volta album cover? Right? And then just go in the room and go, help me! Help me! Right? Like, pour the cold water in her face and just go, help me! Help me! How ruined do you think your kids would be tonight? You could change their entire lives if you went, poured cold water on them, and you had a sheet wrapped around your face, and you're just like, help me! Help me!
You would toughen them up.
Exactly. Toughen them up.
Tough love.
What's the best Lou Reed album, Steve Gunn?
Bells.
The Bells, very interesting.
Street Hassle's pretty good, too.
Actually, I don't
Waves really like of Bells. Fear!
Is that Street that Hassle? Bells? That's not Bells.
It's on Blue Mask.
Yeah, Blue Mask. Yeah. He gets legendary Bob Quine
in the band, and then he just sabotages the record. Lou.
So you say...
I think Metal Machine Music is my favorite.
Seriously?
No.
No? I like Metal Machine Music.
We all like it, but it's not our favorite.
I don't know if it, yeah. So what would you say, honestly? What do you, honestly, you pick
know,
one.
You know which one I really like is Take No Prisoners?
Uh-huh. Yeah,
the live
great.
One.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's, it's so insane.
I think Lou
yeah.
Reed,
it's not, it's like
it's so ridiculous.
As yeah. good as some it. Of his music is, he never, he doesn't have a perfect album.
I mean, Transformer is, you know, of course.
Yeah.
Hold
that's,
on a second. There's no sorry. Perfect Lou Reed album.
Not exactly perfect. They're all great. He's so great, but what's perfect to you?
No, for
that's
me?
Lou
no, no,
Reed,
no.
That's
no,
what
it's
Lou
fine.
Reed's all about.
Yeah.
It's not perfect.
You want to know that's... what? This is what I'll say. I will agree completely with you on this, Kurt.
Coney think... Island, baby, masterpiece. No.
Everybody puts, you put Lou Reed and David Bowie together. It's like, David Bowie's all up in the stars and stuff. Lou Reed's down the street.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And he's never perfect. You're right. He's never perfect. There's always a bad lyric. Like that Magic and Loss, that first thing about the
well, that's the 90s.
But there's that thing about the mayonnaise yeah. milkshake. What is that line?
Egg cream.
Well, not egg cream.
Kurt.
Ice cream, you dream. We all like egg cream.
Egg cream. Sit the twilight, really.
But I listened to all the albums over the last couple months.
Hmm.
And you're right. Nothing's perfect. You know what's perfect? The four Velvet Underground albums.
They are perfect.
Boom, 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 boom.
They're also...
They
are,
laid the template
they're
for everything.
Great. They're great, but also, aside from you, I hate when people, like, still try to praise them. They're like, happy birthday, Lou, Velvet Underground, the greatest... Not you, but other... Like,
nah,
it's
you
also,
hate it when I do it.
No, I love... No, you can do whatever you want, Tom,
not
but this is a musician thing.
What about the Matrix?
It's like there,
box
if there's
set?
Also... There are masterpieces, but it's also a little bit played out.
Oh, no, it's totally played. Look, it's played out because you hear it in
saying,
everything.
Yeah, but there was like, oh, yeah, I want to give a shout-out to Lou and the Velvet Underground, this greatest masterpiece, Velvet Underground, and Nico. Like, no crap.
Okay, well, look at this. Okay, then do this. You take these Lou Reed albums and figure out what the corresponding John Cale album was that year, right?
Whoa.
And then you think about what Velvet Underground album would that have been? If John Cale started dropping some of these songs on the albums.
And Cale, he did the first Stooges album.
Yeah.
Masterpiece.
And the Modern Lovers.
Yeah. Hey, did Patti you see
Smith.
The Danny Fields documentary yet?
I saw some of it.
Danny Says?
I saw some of it.
Pretty good.
I liked what I saw.
Pretty great.
Look, John Cale has more perfect albums than Lou Reed. Right?
Debatable. Yeah.
Do you remember...
Debate? No. Hey,
debate...
We just talked about how all these Lou Reed albums are great.
I'm like riding your coattails. Like, you're like, debatable. I'm like, debatable.
Well, what's the most, what's the most perfect Lou Reed album in your mind?
Magic and Loss?
No.
Look, that's way up there.
Sorry. I
think Kurt might be right. Maybe there is no perfect Lou Reed album.
There isn't.
Yeah. Although maybe the closest, one
would be,
Take No Prisoners.
I don't know that one. The closest one would be Transformer as a production.
See, I think Transformer is actually, definitely. I think Transformer's thinner than people think.
It is, but it's still the big best production. I'll tell you what, his first album, which has a lot of redone Velvet songs, with the song Going Down, and it's got... people from Yes playing in this band.
Yeah.
Rick
Wakeman.
Song Going Down, you should play, you know the song Going Down? It's like one of the only ones that's not a Velvet Underground redo.
Yeah.
When
you
in the dream,
know what else I love
you think?
As well?
And what's you that? Know you're going down.
Like, there's
that's
there's
a great
like
song.
An era of Lou with Robert Quine.
Mm-hmm.
And like, you know how Lou is like this king in Italy?
Mm-hmm.
And there's a live record.
Yeah, Live in Italy.
Live in Italy.
Yeah.
That shit's insane. Yeah. They do a Sister Ray version of that.
It's okay, we're past.
Sorry.
Okay, don't worry, Steve.
They do a version of Sister Ray, and it's really good.
Yeah,
that's all I have to say.
I would say, Take No Prisoners, though.
I think so too.
Because
which one is Take No Prisoners?
It's the double live album.
Yeah, it's like a comic drawing on the front.
Oh, the one where it's like.
Watch me turn into Lou Reed before your very eyes.
Yeah.
The one where he's just like, give me a tissue. Give me an issue, I'll give you a tissue.
He's lashing yeah. out at yeah.
The 15-minute version of Walk on the Wild Side where he explains.
Amazing. He's talking about the journalist, lashing out yeah. at the journalist.
It's so good.
Watch me turn into Lou Reed. I don't have it.
From the bottom line. Right?
Where he's talking about Chris.
So good.
But then at the end, all of a sudden they do the straightest version of Street Hassle on it.
Yeah,
it's just perfect.
Is it?
Perfect.
I gotta get it.
It's really so good. Yeah.
Honestly, there's like a WHYY special from the 90s, which I'm sure we all saw, but like that's like a centerpiece of it. And they even interview the reporter that it was making fun of. So I guess I don't own that album.
Then caller, what do you think the perfect one is then? If you were just like
the perfect album,
debatable.
Terrible.
You were like debatable.
That was just me saying dumb shit. But
hey, you can't curse.
What is this?
I started it.
It's all right.
I did.
It's all right. So, because look, John Cale has perfect albums.
Does he?
I doubt. Yes, Paris 1919.
Have you ever like seen Lou on the street or anything like that?
Well, he's dead now.
I know,
I saw a tweet where you at least said you saw him. Maybe
I was making all that stuff up. I claimed he was sitting across from me in a Starbucks, and that was a whole long running.
I saw him once, and I got up the guts to go and say hi.
You did?
Yeah. Was he nice?
He was nice, yeah.
I
worked at an art gallery, and there was this, this artist, Julian Schnabel.
Mm-hmm.
I love the work.
It was a bit of a ridiculous situation, but he had this art show, and I was like the guy who... You know, I got asked to kind of just be a security guard of sorts, and there was a private viewing/party for Julian's art show, whatever. It was totally ridiculous. But all these
people he directed the live Berlin thing.
And he did Diving Bell and the Butterfly. He knew a lot of people, so that he had this little party, and I was working with my friend, and Lou was just there, and we were just hired to kind of close up and sweep up, you know, after the party or whatever, but we were, like, hanging around,
after
and
Lou.
All these people were there, and I was like, you know what, let's just go up and talk to him, just stand there, and we went up to him, and it was a really boring story, but...
No, it's not.
Just went up to him, and I was, you know, I just said, hey, Lou, he's like, hey, shook his hand. We chit-chatted for a little bit.
It's awesome.
And it was relaxed and great. Yeah, it was super fun. Super cool.
It's kind of like me and Patti Smith in the elevator when I ran into Patti. No, that went the opposite of...
How'd that go?
It didn't go well, and I don't... I went into an elevator with her, and then I asked her if she ever saw Humble Pie back in the day. And then she looked terrified. Not great. It's like... AP Mike, where you ran into Bruce Springsteen when you were a kid, right?
Well, when he's a kid's better than now.
Mike ran into him in 78.
And he's like, that's very far.
When he had, it was a darkness. And then Mike was asking him all these questions.
That's beautiful.
And like Mike asked him, they asked him something. Bruce was talking to them so much that at a point Mike was like, we have to get going.
Wow.
And they had to leave Bruce Springsteen.
Well, that's beautiful.
Like, Bruce Springsteen was just like, because Mike was a kid, and he's just like, am I doing this right, Mike?
It's too much.
Mike was just like, how much do you get paid for a show when you do a thing? And Bruce is like, well, you know, we get paid. Like, he's answering every question completely, sincerely, and just talking and talking and talking so much. Mike and his friend are finally like, we gotta go, dude. Sorry, you're talking too much.
Folks, I gotta go.
All right. Speaking of gotta go.
Oh, man.
It's time to go. Any final things, you guys?
I love you. Peace. I love you so much.
I love you, Kurt.
Thanks for having me.
You know that, of course. Thanks, Steve, for coming.
Come visit me in Ocean City. I'll be there with my wife and two daughters. I just want to give a shout out to Lou and Rachel.
Eat at that pizza place?
Yeah, eat at that pizza place.
Manco's?
Mac and Manco's. Or right? Manco and Manco.
No. They broke up. Who? Mac and Manco.
No, but that pizza place, Manco and Manco, is
now
that what it
Manco
is?
Now
Manco.
It is, yeah.
Yeah.
It's a good slice.
They had a falling out as love as often will.
I ate at that pizza place, right? I was just like, all right, I get it. It's very good.
didn't change my life.
Yeah, it's not a...
There's like people lined up waiting to get pizza at this place.
Yeah.
Like, really?
That's guys, just...
It's Shore Pizza. Come on, guys.
I can't even eat the cheese anymore.
So, everyone.
Yeah. On that
my
note,
friend Kurt Vile.
See you later.
First of all, you did that song that had my name in it, which was the sweetest thing ever. And that'll be a part of this secret project.
Oh,
maybe.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Absolutely. So that will be on a record.
I think so. Unless it doesn't make the cut.
How can it not make the cut?
It's going to make the cut.
It's got to make the cut.
Yeah, well, I wrote that and I was thinking about you, Tom.
No, that's on the three-lobed split that you guys did. Cool. That's a great one, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Was that parallelogram?
You're telling me? Of course it was great.
So... But you're working on a secret album that's going to come out.
Yeah.
You're directing a porno movie.
Yes, I am. And it's great.
Yeah, and you're also working on some stuff for the next proper KV album.
Well, thank you for asking.
And 2017 is going to be a big... 2018 is going to be a big year for both of you because, Steve, you're also working on some new stuff.
Yes.
That will come out.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't wait. I tell you.
Cool.
And I'm all still up. Me and you can be in a really Oscar-winning movie together as well, a comedy.
Look, I'm ready to do a thing. I'm done. Look.
I want to be in it. Come on.
You want to be in it? You're funny. I know you're funny.
I want to be in it. Give me a chance.
Look.
What is it? Give me a chance.
Look.
Okay.
I've had a hard time. Kurt, Steve, Paul, Mike, Dudio, Pat. Y'all know. This is not easy days. A few months ago, got in a car accident. Then a month or so after that, lost my job. I was in the hole. In the tank, in the toilet, in the can. And I bottomed out, baby. I was down there, and I'll tell you, you know what, the best thing about it, I realized it was a gift. A problem never comes along without a gift in the hand. That's what they say, Dudio. Did you know that? A problem never comes along without a gift in its hand. And I said to myself, so many times, where's the gift? Where's the gift? I see the problem. I don't see the gift. Try as I may, try as I might, the gift never showed up until 2 weeks ago when I said to myself, you know what? You can't stop me. You can't stop me, these bums and half-wits who tried to bring me down. Take my money from me. I don't care. I'm not just money. Am I just a receptacle for money? No. You want to live with money as some sort of code and some sort of metric for what's good or bad in your life? Fine. You're going to rot for it. You're going to rot if that's what you're living by. I'm here for quality. I'm here for eternity. I'm here to do the good stuff. That's what I'm here for. I'm making stuff that matters. So I took my computer, I started writing, I wrote like crazy, like the veritable wind did I write. Finished a thing, slammed the lid on it, it's done, I'm starting the next thing tomorrow, I'm back, I'm going to start just cranking these things out, because it's a war out there. It's a war, Kurt. Steve, Paul, Mike, Dudio, Pat.
Bob, Dylan.
Bob, Neil, Macho Man. And I say, not unlike the late, great Macho Man Randy Savage said, he said, the cream rises to the top. Oh, yeah, is what he said. The cream rises to the top. And we are the cream. We are the cream. And we are now rising. Watch us rise. Best show. Back next week. Bye.